NC State Wolfpack. Temperatures tonight will be cold, mid-30s to near 40. We do have a frost advisory in effect. And then for tomorrow and Sunday, we'll see partly cloudy skies and highs in the low to mid-60s.
Weather update brought to you by Newcomb & Company, where your comfort is their business. Visit NewcombandCompany.com. 3 o'clock check of your money. The Dow Jones up 296 points at 38,893. Market update brought to you by the Goodfeet Store. You're invited to Sanford's 150th birthday bash Saturday, April 6th, 10:30 a.m. to 4. This is a free event happening at Sanford Fairgrounds. Get all the details at Sanford150.com.
Love guarded by Keels, gets a screen, pulls up for three. Got it! Caleb from straight away!
Jones with one. Jones puts it up at the buzzer. Yes! He ties the game!
Joyner with a long rebound, kicks ahead to Smith. Three ball, right side.
Bang! Shotgun snap, Bryce Young, pressure off the backside. Throw to the end zone. Chark pulls it in with his fingertips.
And another chance, and the save's made by Anderson. And the fans will tell you, did you have a good night?
On Drive with Tim Donnelly on 99.9 The Fan.
The Drive with Tim Donnelly, 99.9 The Fan. I'm Tim Donnelly, Graham Hill producing the show. We'll hear from Dennis Cox a little bit later on. It's here, ladies and gentlemen. The Final Four for the NC State women starts tonight. The Final Four for the NC State men start tomorrow. All week we've been building up to this, and this being our final episode of The Drive, our final show before those games kick off. And don't try to sell me on it's just any other game. Doesn't it feel like we've been talking about the importance of this game for months now?
Forever.
Imagine how it feels for the players. Imagine everything they've gone through, the Applebee's trips, the practices, the travel, the media opportunities, the walkthroughs. It's not any other game. It's not. It can't be. Pretending it is just ignoring the elephant in the room. As much as the teams try to say there is. By the way, we're going to open up the phone lines here.
Let's go.
Heister Automotive Group Hotline. This is your last chance to get some words in, to get a message in. What's your take? What's your NC State needs to do this to win? They will win because of this. They're going to lose because of that. I don't know. It's open phone lines. 919-860-5326. You'll be hearing from me and Graham throughout the show. We want to hear from you. It's your last chance to get a word in. 919-860-5326, Heister Automotive Group Hotline. It's not just any other game. Despite what Purdue is telling you, here's Fletcher Lawyer, one of their shooters from the outside, talking about how Purdue is treating this Final Four matchup.
It's win or go home, so you got to treat it like a basketball game. It's not a show. It's a game. And I think us being locked in, getting our feel for the court, but ultimately knowing it's still 10-foot rim, same amount of length out there.
Yeah.
Coach's talk.
It is, you know, that's the Hoosiers thing, right? 10-foot rims, it's all the same. I get it. I hear you. It's not any other game. Your heart rate, it's going to be higher at tip-off. The amount of eyeballs, it's being played in a football stadium. The amount of eyeballs on television, it's not any other game. Matter of fact, we have about 40 games, you know, almost 40 games from each team to decide who the good players are and what they need to be successful. I think we have a pretty good idea of what these teams are. But the part we have no research on is how any of these teams, meaning Purdue and NC State, play under the bright lights of Final Four pressure. We know how some of the UConn guys play because we've seen that, but Alabama, Purdue, and NC State, we don't know. And it's not all about, oh, pressure bursts pipes. Sometimes pressure makes diamonds. Some people play better under all that pressure. It wakes up something inside them. I was just listening to an interview with Penn from Penn and Teller, right? The magicians, the guy that used to have the ponytail and his partner didn't talk. And he was talking about they were on Saturday Night Live in like the 80s. And they had a trick that they never pulled off before. If you go back and watch it, they were actually hanging upside down. It's a whole thing. But they never nailed it. Went through all the dress rehearsals, all the everything, never nailed the trick. Guess what? You put them on, I think it was 8 million people watching live on Saturday night. It was obviously live broadcast, Saturday Night Live. Drilled it. And his argument was when you turn all the lights on, they perform better. Some people are that way. Some people are Penn and Teller. We don't know. NC State, I believe, has to be more comfortable in it than Purdue because they've just been living under pressure for 9 games versus 4. I don't think anyone is choosing NC State's path. Like, if you have options, I don't think anyone is saying, like, you know what I really wish? I really wish we had 9 winner-go-home games. But now that you've made it through all 9, maybe it's some kind of advantage. Maybe it's some kind of you're more comfortable than they are. Maybe it's a blessing in disguise. Maybe it's the opposite, and you're so exhausted from being under pressure, eventually you'll break down. That's, you know, to be determined. But there is that possibility. I mentioned the phone lines are open. Heister Automotive Group Hotline, 919-860-5326. Today's your last chance to get a thought in before the Final Four. We have Pat from Durham. He was on the line first, waiting patiently. Pat, thank you for calling in. What's your final word? What's your last comment before the Final Four gets underway?
Well, first comment is, man, my heart's getting ready to jump out of my chest, I feel like. But I was... You know, ZD's so good in the middle, and he has all these moves. And I don't know if I've heard this before, but how about if you pressure the ball and maybe they start, you know, with 15 seconds left or 16 seconds left? He has less time to do what he does. And maybe that would be a way to, you only have to play defense maybe for 8 to 10 seconds. And also, is he a good passer? Out of a double team or something like that. Have you heard about that?
I'll answer both those questions. Appreciate the call, Pat. Call back in anytime. First of all, you're definitely going to see ball pressure. And the people you're going to see it from are Casey Morsell and most likely Michael O'Connell, and they are going to try to make that perimeter work for the exact reason you just said. Right? You want Zach Edey catching the ball with the fewest amount of seconds on the shot clock possible, but also – right, there's this talk about this college basketball season being a resurgence of the big, right? All the big men are driving again. There's also a resurgence of the post entry pass. Like, if you watch the NBA, nobody knows how to throw the ball into the post. And that's obviously what everyone's watching growing up. So I would test them. I mean, obviously Purdue's going to be good at it because they've been throwing it into Zach Edey for the past 4 years. But yeah, there's definitely going to be ball pressure, and that can definitely help things. And the side note is, yeah, Edey can pass out of the double. And part of that is just being 7'4 and tall. The vision, it's going to be easier for him because he's looking over everybody. He can pass out of the double team. I wouldn't say he's as prodigious a passer or as polished a passer as somebody like DJ Burns, who just kind of has that instinct. But if you double team Zach Edey, he has shooters that can knock it down. Stephen Raleigh, next up on the call-in line, which is open, by the way, for Final Four talk, 919-860-5326. Steve from Raleigh, what's your final take, your last words before the Final Four gets underway?
Hey, guys. Thanks for taking my call.
Mm-hmm.
My first thing is congratulations to NC State. It's very exciting. I'm not from the area. I haven't seen them or known that much about their program since they've been kind of down for several years, but I think it's amazing for the men and the women. My second comment is a little bit more pointed, and that is, why is there not more coverage on this radio station or any radio station about the women's game? I listen every day to Adam Gold, I listen to you, and they get about 20 seconds of coverage every hour compared to...
Okay, all right, hold on now. I'm not going to let you... I assume that was an exaggeration because if you've been listening, you know that I've made a point to bring up the women every single day for significantly longer than 20 seconds per hour. Is he still there?
It hasn't been much.
It's been significantly more than 20 seconds per hour.
Well, that's hyperbole, you know, exaggerating to make a point.
Well, okay, but when you're speaking on the radio, you have to make those things obvious because people out there are taking them seriously. What do you want to talk about with the women?
Well, I'm super excited because my son is actually a student at South Carolina, and their women's team is amazing. So I'm a little bit conflicted tonight in this game because I want State to win because I'm in Raleigh, and I'm impressed by them. But then again, I want the Gamecocks to win because amazing team and amazing result if they go undefeated. So I'm just hoping that game tonight's going to be awesome. I think the women have put on a great show this year, and I'm super excited to see what they do.
All right. Appreciate the call. I'll add in my two cents about the women, which, by the way, we've been, like I said, making a point to cover. Not as much as the men. I'm not going to, you know, pull the wool over your eyes. But there's definitely, especially this year, more conversation about women's basketball than we've ever seen in the past. They're making strides in all of those ways. Sanaya Rivers. Let's talk about her. If you're going to talk about this game, you want to talk about being conflicted. She has a national championship ring on her finger from her time at South Carolina. Her freshman year, they won a national championship. She was a South Carolina Gamecock. Now she's in the Final Four trying to keep South Carolina from winning another with NC State. And my favorite part is in the media lead up, Sanaya said if they win, and then she corrected herself and said when they win, she might have to break out both rings. She might be celebrating an NC State championship with a South Carolina Gamecocks ring on her finger that she won as a freshman. You want to talk about conflicted? There's some conflicted arguments or some conflicted internal thoughts going on there. The Drive with Tim Donnelly, 99.9 The Fan. The wait is over, everybody. I'm Tim Donnelly for my friends at DraftKings Sportsbook, an official sports betting partner of NASCAR. They're now live in North Carolina. Now you can legally bet on all your favorite sports anytime, anywhere, right here in North Carolina with DraftKings. For a limited time, new customers who sign up with promo code TIMD, T-I-M-D, and bet $5 will receive $250 instantly in bonus bets. And for that last caller, men's tourney, women's tourney, you can use those bets wherever you'd like on college basketball. DraftKings has the best features, including same-game parlays, player props, and more with fast and easy payouts right at your fingertips. Download the DraftKings Sportsbook app now using code TIMD, that's Tim D with no spaces, and bet $5 to get $250 instantly in bonus bets only on DraftKings Sportsbook with code TIMD. The crown is yours. Gambling problem? Call 877-185-543 or visit morethanagame.nc.gov. 21 plus, North Carolina only. Bonus bets expire 168 hours after issuance. Deposit and eligibility restrictions apply. Terms at DraftKings.com/sportsbook/NC. NASCAR is not a sponsor of this promotion and used under license. We're going to talk to our very own Dennis Cox from Phoenix coming up next and more Final Four talk. Don't go anywhere.
Get crazy, Canes fans. It's hockey night in Carolina.
He scores! Dmitri Orlov picks the corner, and the Canes take a 2-1 lead.
Storm Watch with Adam Gold at 6:30. Puck drop at 7.
Second chance, they score!
Exclusive home for the Carolina Hurricanes, 99.9 The Fan.
What are you doing?
I'm training for the new Ultimate Dash Scratch-Offs. I could get a chance to dash through a warehouse full of prizes.
That explains the shopping cart.
Plus, I could win up to $2 million in cash.
And that explains the tuxedo.
I'm chafing.
Feel the rush with new Ultimate Dash Scratch-Offs from the North Carolina Education Lottery. Must be 18 to play. Approximate overall odds of winning are 1 in 3.78. Problem gambling helpline, 877-718-5543.
A torn ACL, stress fracture, aching back, a hip that's had it, life on hold, and all you want is to get it back. Enter Wake Orthopedics. Our fellowship-trained orthopedists do it all. General, sports, pediatric, joint replacement, fracture, spine, prevention, advanced diagnostics, progressive treatments, minimally invasive procedures, surgeries, and more. Visit wakemed.org/wakeortho and get back your life.
It's bow time. Something new just dropped at Bojangles. Take the bold taste of a crispy golden chicken supreme that's been seasoned to perfection, then add dill pickles, Carolina Gold barbecue sauce, and a toasted bun that's great on the go. What do you get? You get a Bo's Bird Dog. In fact, you can grab two of them for $5. So when you're on the go, headed to practice, or need a snack, grab a Bo's Bird Dog. Hurry in before they're gone. Available for a limited time. It's bow time.
There's no time like bow time, but sometimes it's go time. No time to stop. Introducing Bojangles' new Bird Dog, a seasoned to perfection Bojangles Chicken Supreme, dill pickles, Carolina Gold barbecue sauce, all on a toasted bun. Great on the go. Try two Bird Dogs for just $5 or a two Bird Dog combo for just $8. Hurry, Bo's Bird Dogs are available for a limited time only. When you're hungry for flavor and value, it's Bo time.
What could be better than living less than 15 minutes from downtown Raleigh, where you'll soon find an expansive greenway network with walking trails, a pool with a lazy river, and a dog park? How about choosing from a diverse portfolio of plans, including large homes with a three-car garage or Charleston-inspired homes with rear-entry garages? At George's Landing by Mungo Homes, you'll find an exceptional location with an even better lifestyle. Go to Mungo.com today to learn more about George's Landing near downtown Raleigh. Mungo.com.
Now is the time to switch to Spectrum. Get Spectrum Internet delivering fast and reliable speeds for just $49.99 a month. Plus free advanced Wi-Fi for enhanced security and a free Spectrum Mobile Unlimited line with nationwide 5G. Ask how you can get a Visa Rewards card up to $500 when you add more mobile lines. Internet, advanced Wi-Fi, and mobile. Get it all with Spectrum One. Go to Spectrum.com for full details. Offer subject to change. Valid for qualified residential customers only. Restrictions apply.
With Progressive's Home Quote Explorer, you can check if you're paying too much for home insurance, because giving you options is the right thing to do.
Oh yeah, like bringing brownies to a dinner party. But I never bring brownies with nuts, because not everyone likes nuts, so they wouldn't eat those brownies. And even people who do like nuts will still eat brownies without them. Why? Because they're brownies.
But still, it's the right thing to do. So compare rates with Progressive's Home Quote Explorer. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company, affiliates, and third-party insurers. Not available in all states or situations. Prices vary based on how you buy.
Hey, everyone. It's Ted from Consumer Cellular, the guy in the orange sweater. And this is your wake-up call. If you're paying too much for wireless service, you don't have to keep having that nightmare. Consumer Cellular has the same fast, reliable coverage as the leading carriers for up to half the cost. So why keep spending more than you have to? Seriously, wake up and call 1-888-FREEDOM or visit ConsumerCellular.com.
Savings based on cost of Consumer Cellular single line 1, 5, and 10 gig data plans with unlimited talk and text compared to lowest cost single line postpaid unlimited talk, text, and data plans offered by T-Mobile and Verizon January 2024.
The Drive with Tim Donnelly, 99.9 The Fan. It is the last day before the Final Four. Last show before the Final Four. And we're opening up the phone lines today for your final thoughts on the action going on this weekend. Heister Automotive Group Hotline, 919-860-5326. Feel free to call in with your thoughts, your questions, your concerns, your statements. I'm big on receipts. Okay, so what I mean by that is, if there's a prediction you want or you think or a question you want to ask, don't call in Monday and say, I knew all along, I told you. And I'm going to go, well, we had the phone lines open. Did you call in and tell us? Or are we just supposed to take your word for it, right? Where's your receipt? Proof of purchase, proof of take. 919-860-5326. We'll be checking in with Dennis Cox from Phoenix in the not-too-distant future. However, I also want to bring this up. And by the way, there's a new edition of the Pack Therapy podcast out now. Graham and I chopped up a lot of our final thoughts going into the Final Four weekend. There's a very large kind of a marquee sign, right? Neon blinking like it's a boxing fight in Vegas with like Tyson and Holyfield that says Burns versus Edie. Burns versus Edie. It's DJ Burns, Zach Edie. Which, you know, rightfully so. The thing that no one's really talking about is how much the refs will affect that one. And I hate it. You hate it. Graham hates it. Every basketball player ever hates it. But the fact of the matter is that the ref is kind of like the golf course, right? Your style of play has to match up with the golf course. Do you need to be accurate? Skinny fairways? Do you need to be a bomber? Do you need to hit it a mile? Do you need to be able to have a get out of the rough? Like, whatever it is, a ref can help decide that. Those two guys, Burns and Edie, they can beat each other in different styles, right? If they are playing ticky-tack, if they are playing every bump is a foul, I really like DJ Burns' opportunity here because he is fantastic at creating contact when he has the ball. If they let him play, it's hard not to argue for the guy with the longer arms, the guy with the obviously the height, 7'4", in Zach Edey. And then the other thing is, do you think anyone wants to watch a long stretch of game, a long stretch of the game, any part of it? Do you think they want to watch a game without either of those two guys? They're the box office, right? Those two guys are the ones who everybody's tuning in to see. If the refs swallow their whistle and say, I'm not fouling them out, I think that gives Purdue an advantage. I think that could be a problem for NC State. If Zach Edey is out of the game, Purdue doesn't have anyone taller than DJ Burns that plays big minutes. If Zach Edey is out with foul trouble, if Zach Edey can't play physical, Purdue doesn't have anyone taller than DJ Burns that plays real minutes, which means if Zach Edey gets in foul trouble, Purdue's post defense looks a lot like all the other defenses that DJ Burns has been cooking for the past month. So if there's fouls built up on Edey, either that'll make Edey sit or it'll make him play conservative. Either way, I think Burns wins that matchup. If the refs go into the game saying this is the final four, we're going to let him settle it on the floor, and they let Edey get physical with Burns, I think that could be a tough one for NC State. Phone lines are open. We have another caller coming in. This is Court. Am I pronouncing that right? Court from Raleigh. Court, thank you for calling in. What's your last message heading into the final four?
Perimeter defense. I think that's going to be the difference in the game.
From which team or which
from
like?
From NC State.
Okay.
From NC State. And I go back and look and have reviewed Marquette and Duke. In the second half, both games, State's perimeter defense basically shut them down. I think that if they can do this against Purdue, the big guy in the middle, Edie's going to get his, so be it. Prevent everybody else from even getting half of what they typically get and throw the three big men at Edey during the course of the game. Again, if the referees are consistent, mm-hmm. that's one thing.
Yep.
If they're inconsistent, then that's a whole different ballgame. I think you got to go ahead and calculate that the big man is going to get it.
Okay.
Shut down everybody else.
Yep.
That's my thoughts.
I appreciate it, Court. And it is – you know, there's kind of two trains of thought. Thank you for calling in. One is you do everything you can to stop their best player. The other is you recognize you're not going to stop their best player and you make life very difficult for everyone else. The challenge there is, you know, Zach Edey can put up 40. It's the same way we look at teams playing against State saying they've never seen anything like DJ Burns. You can say the same against Zach Edey. It's just as tough in that direction as it is in the others. With that being said, perimeter defense, it's these games, right? Once you get to this point, teams are good at just about everything, right? Yes, perimeter defense is wildly important. Wildly important. The lawyer, Smith, like these shooters for Purdue will knock it down if they can find the space. So there's no doubt in my mind the perimeter defense has to be on point for NC State, as Court described. The only thing is, if the post defense isn't on point, the ball's never coming back out, right? The shots come after the ball goes into Edey. He gets stopped. He gets uncomfortable, and he kicks it back out. If the post defense isn't there, the perimeter defense never has a chance to show that they're in position. So it really is a difficult back and forth there when you look at both sides of it. The Drive with Tim Donnelly, 99.9 The Fan. I want to tell you about my friends over at Window Nation. Here's the deal. It's cold. It's cold. It's hot. It's cold. It's hot. We know how the weather is in North Carolina. Well, weather impacts your windows. Hot days and cold nights can cause caulk to crack, seals to fail, condensation. Window Nation only uses the top-of-the-line materials, including mold spray and Quad Max sealant, toughest against all weather conditions. So let them come out to your house, meaning let a consultant from Window Nation come out to your house, look at your windows, explain how their windows can help lower your energy fee, right, your energy bill every month, and raise the cost of your home, raise the value of your home. It's very easy. Give them a call, 866-90-NATION. That's 866-90-NATION. Or visit windownation.com to schedule now. That's windownation.com. BoTime.com. We're going to be back with the head coach of Boston College men's basketball, Earl Grant. He has a seven-footer, Quentin Post. Maybe he can give us some insight into this rise in big men in college basketball. And he played against NC State, so he's going to have a unique view on guarding DJ Burns and the rest of the Wolfpack. Earl Grant joining us on the Heister Automotive Group Hotline coming up.
It's the first day of the first grade, and she found a new best friend. It's a laid-back Sunday afternoon you wish would never end.
The homemade taste of Bluebell and good friends gathered round. The good old days are being made right now.
St. Louis brought the world gooey butter cake. Now Bluebell brings us gooey butter cake ice cream, a cake batter ice cream with a luscious cream cheese swirl and gooey butter cake pieces. Mmm, it's the gateway to the best in pints and half gallons.
The good old days are being made right now.
The good old days are being made right now.
Look for Bluebell ice cream at Walmart Supercenters and Walmart Neighborhood Markets.
At Bet365, we don't do ordinary. We believe that every sport should be epic. Every point, every game, every layup, every play. From the moments that are legendary to the ones that fly under the radar. Whether it's a three-pointer at the buzzer to tie the game or a player goes 2-for-2 at the free throw line. Whatever the sport, whatever the moment, it's never ordinary. At Bet365, official partner of the Charlotte Hornets. 21 plus only. Gambling problem? Call 1-877-718-5543 or visit morethanagame.nc.gov.
My kids call me Tom. So unnerving. Every day, the older one's like, how you doing, Tom? I go, hey, I'm not your f***ing stepdad, all right? I wish I was. It'd be a lot easier, but I'm not.
From his multiple Netflix specials, comedian Tom Segura brings his new tour, Come Together, to PNC Arena Raleigh, April 14th. Tickets on sale now at Ticketmaster.com or PNCArena.com.
Texting enrolls you into reoccurring automated text messages. Consent not required to purchase. Message and data rates may apply.
Hey, Dan, how you doing? Haven't seen you around the gym for a while.
Yeah, I've really fallen off. Since I turned 40, I just don't get the results I used to get.
Could be lower testosterone.
Lower T?
Yeah, I went through it a while back. Once you hit 40, your body has less free testosterone. I got Nugenix Total T, and it's made a huge difference for me.
I've seen that ad on TV. Is it for real?
Oh, yeah. The key ingredient is something called Tesnor, which helps boost free and total testosterone levels to help you trim up and stay lean.
And it's made a difference for you?
Man, I feel like I'm in my 20s again, at work, in the gym, and in the bedroom.
Are they still giving out complimentary bottles for people to try it for themselves?
Yeah, you just need to send them a text.
Text HIM to 321-321 right now for your complimentary bottle of Nugenix Total T, the number one selling testosterone booster at GNC. Plus, text now and we'll include a bottle of Nugenix Thermo, our most powerful fat incinerator ever, to help you get back into shape fast, absolutely free. Text HIM to 321-321. That's HIM to 321-321.
The future of medicine is here at QC Kinetics. QC is the nation's leader in the most exciting revolution in pain management we've seen in decades, regenerative medicine. If you are tired of achy joints, if your joint pain is keeping you from doing what you love, you need to call QC Kinetics now. Surgery, steroids, drugs, these are no longer your best options. Regenerative medicine at QC Kinetics is transforming lives with innovative treatments that deliver lasting results. We're talking natural biologics, using your body's own power to repair and restore damaged tissue. QC Kinetics is under the leadership of National Medical Director Dr. Mitchell Sheencup. Dr. Sheencup is a pioneer in this field with 20 years of clinical work, tons of research, teaching, and publishing. He wants to get you relief with a needle, not a knife. Call QC Kinetics now to learn more about some exciting options. This is a revolutionary approach that can get you long-term relief with no downtime. 919-400-5473. With locations in Cary, Clayton, Raleigh, and Wake Forest. 919-400-5473.
Imagine waking up this time next week and being 100% debt-free. No credit cards, no car loan, no personal loan. Hey, it's Dennis Cox. Loan Pronto's Equity Express line of credit can make it happen. Homeowners are turning their home equity into cash almost instantly. With Loan Pronto's AI-based system, you can get approval in about 10 minutes. With almost no documentation, no appraisal, and no hassle, you can get hundreds of thousands of dollars out of your home. Use that money to pay off all your other loans. The average homeowner saves over $850 a month doing this. Listen, Your home value is way up. You can use that to wipe out all those credit cards, get some money for a home improvement. Literally hundreds of thousands are at your fingertips, and approval is just minutes away. Call 919-381-1760, 919-381-1760, loanpronto.com, 919-381-1760, NMLS 1661781, subject to lender approval, equal housing lender.
Yeah, cash money, heroes, private jets, polish, they shine.
The Drive with Tim Donnelly, 99.9 The Fan. I'm told we have Earl Grant, Boston College head basketball coach, on the Heister Automotive Group hotline, ready to give us his insight into the tourney, into college basketball as a whole. Coach Grant, thank you very much for taking the time to join us here. As hey, we got you on video even for everybody watching our live streams. We'll start with the big guy. You played DJ Burns twice this year. You held them under 50% shooting both times. Nobody in the NCAA tournament has done that yet. What's the trick?
Well, you know, the first thing is it's really hard to deal with DJ. But, you know, I'm happy for him. You know, when I was at College of Charleston, he was on campus as a ninth grader. So I've known DJ a lot of years. Saw when he went to Tennessee and then left and Winthrop. And so, you know, I was really happy for him. But he's a load. You know, you play him one-on-one. It's hard to stop him at his size and his kind of nimble. He's like a ballerina, you know. So if you play him one-on-one, he know how to maneuver and get to where you want to go. And then if you double him, he's like a magician. You know, he get it out and his teammates make three. So it's really a hard matchup for anybody.
What do you remember about him as an eighth grader? Did you see that? I mean, I can't imagine all of that size was there yet. Did you see the potential for what he's become?
Yeah, it seemed like he was the same size when I first met him, you know. Seemed like he always been 6'9", 300, you know. But
275 listed, Coach, because we all believe that, right?
I would say this. The thing I remember the most is his personality and his spirit. You know, he was very energetic, very personable. He's like a big teddy bear. So I think when you look at him, he looked like a big giant, this, you know, mean, nasty guy. But he's actually a really kind of like a gentle giant.
We're talking with Earl Grant, Boston College head basketball coach. Coach, I was really impressed. We were at the ACC tournament, saw your team. I was really impressed with Quentin Post. Bigger dude even than he's listed when you kind of see him up close and powerful guy. Looking at the Final Four, we've talked about DJ Burns. There's Zach Edey. There's Klingon. There's guys like Post. Is the center position fully back?
You know, I would say this. It obviously is helping. It helps your team when you have a dominant inside presence. And so I think, obviously, it's going to be like Jurassic Park 3 when DJ and the big fella go against each other, you know, Big Edey. Mm-hmm. That's the first game, right?
Purdue. Yep, North yep, Carolina Purdue. State.
So it'll be like Jurassic Park. you can throw the ball to those guys and get out of the way. Both can score. Both can pass. And then Klingon, you know, from UConn is, you know, I see him a lot because they're in the Northeast. You know, just his size, you know, being able to get those high-low catches. Most of his baskets come without dribbling. So that'll be a challenge for anybody. You know, so I do think the center position is back. Our center was more like a point center. He could step out and shoot the three. I don't think these guys are taking threes. Our guy can go inside and out.
I did notice that. The three-point percentage for yours is, I mean, DJ Burns and Edey, who we were just talking about, kind of that Jurassic Park matchup, they're not going to the three-point line unless there's, you know, no time on the shot clock. Is there anything you can kind of glean, though, from how State guarded Post and how they might guard Edey? Because there's not many comparisons you can make to, like, oh, you know, to guard Edey, we're going to do the same thing we did to this other guy because there's just not that many other guys like him.
You know, I think that NC State do a great job scheming. You know, me and Kevin Keats hadn't shaken each other. We've been in the CAA or the ACC for the last 10 years together. So I've seen him scheme. And he does a great job of finding a way, if you have a great inside force, to disrupt him. So I would imagine they would have a great plan. You know, I know they try to do it against us where they would put, you know, a power forward on Quentin Post and switch everything. And if he go on the inside, they take the five man and, you know, play him with a man and a half. And so I'm sure he'll have a great scheme, you know, against Edey.
And I also believe they'll try to pick up the full court press to make it hard to get it into them easy by pressuring the ball and forcing them perimeter players to work to get it up the court.
You just made one of our callers' day. They suggested the exact same thing as far as picking up full press and having perimeter pressure make it difficult to even get it down into them. So, you know, you're co-signing one of our callers. They're having the day right now getting that kind of approval. We're talking with Earl Grant, Boston College head basketball coach from Phoenix, where the Final Four is getting started. From the inside, why is the national media so dead set on telling us that the ACC is down this year? And you know, even after they four in the Sweet 16 and everything else, they're still sticking to their guns on it. I can't make any sense of it.
Well, I think it's ridiculous, you know, I mean, because obviously we left another team out. Like,
yep.
Pittsburgh was one of the better teams we played. And so I think it's a ridiculous narrative. I believe it's more optics as it pertains to the coaches that we've lost versus the performance that we give. Because the last 3 years, all you got to do is look at the Elite Eight and the Final Four.
Yep.
I mean, you got, I think 2 years ago, we had two or three teams in the, we had two teams in the Final Four. I know that. This year, we had three or four in the Elite Eight. So now we got another one in the Final Four. So I would say the fact that Coach K, Roy Williams, Boeheim, Mike Bray, you know, some people who've been in the league for a lot of years who have a voice, you know, when you look at them, you say, oh, the league is great. And then you lose those guys, you just kind of automatically feel that the league is down. But the games are still being played and the teams are still performing. It's just some big-time name coaches aren't in the league anymore. So I think it's connected to that.
Another question I have for you, and this is kind of a bigger college basketball question. You look at this NC State roster, pretty much every main contributor is a transfer that was not recruited out of high school. I know you guys are in kind of a dead period during the Final Four, but up until, you know, just recently, those conversations were happening. Is that good for college basketball? I know everybody kind of falls in a different path on it. What do you think of the transfer crisscrossing the country world?
Whether it's good or not, I mean, it's here, right? Because if you can ask 25 people, is it good or is it bad for college basketball, it's probably going to be, you know, half and half. There is some good. Quentin Post was a transfer, so I can't say it's not any good. You know, Mason Mattson was a transfer. So in terms of our program moving forward and getting to where we are today, transfers have helped us. You know, I think with NC State, if you look at their roster, you know, you're going into the game for the scouting report and you're trying to talk to your players about their team, you go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, you go to the sixth man, the seventh man, all of them transfers. And so obviously that's made an impact on their program, but they did a good job because they got the right guys. You know, I don't think you can always get the right guys when you speed date to try to recruit, but they did a really good job of selecting the right guys. I mean, obviously McConnell, you know, you saw what he did against Virginia. That's a transfer, right? That's a first-year guy banking that shot in. You know, they're not where they are today without that shot going in.
I have to ask, right? You brought up how close it was against Virginia. Your own game pretty darn close against Virginia. Does part of you think like, hey, this should be us? Look like we were 1 inch away, and then there was 1 inch there. That's just the way March is, but it has to be frustrating.
Yeah, it's a thin line between love and hate. You know what I mean? Because if that shot don't go in, people hating Keats.
Mm-hmm.
That shot went in, they loving him. So it's a thin line between love and hate. You know, I never really thought, hey, that could have been us. But when I was watching the game, NC State versus Virginia, and Virginia was at the free throw line up three with the free throws, and then Virginia don't foul, and the ball goes in, it was deja vu of our game the night before, because we made a long two. Mason Mattson had his toes on the line. He made the three, we win.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, so it was deja vu, game going to overtime, and then NC State was able to close it out.
Coach, we appreciate all your insight and into not just the Final Four, but all college basketball, and good luck this offseason.
Appreciate it, man.
Once again, that's Earl Grant, Boston College head basketball coach. That's a good example. Boston College is a good example of an inch could be a mile in college basketball. He brought it up, right? His player hits what looked like a three. His foot was on the line and ends up being a two. They go to overtime, lose to Virginia. Then the next day, Virginia, we all saw the O'Connell, I think he called him McConnell, but it was O'Connell, hits the shot to force overtime for NC State. That is two of the smallest margin of error plays. If they go the other way, then it's Boston College possibly going into the ACC championship, and who knows how this all breaks down, but it's a good one there. Speaking of the Heister Automotive Group hotline, we need to talk to our very own Dennis Cox, who we have locked up from Phoenix. Dennis, good to see you. Good to hear from you.
Yeah, good to see you guys.
We'll start the same way we started yesterday. Vibe check. Yesterday you said NC State was still the same they've been. As it gets closer, it's going to become more and more difficult. Are they still pulling that off?
So one thing that Kevin Keats talked about yesterday in his press availability, he said they wanted to treat yesterday like 50-50, like have fun and also business, right? Because you don't want to be like mentally tax your guys out, you know, 2 days away from a game. So he made sure before practice yesterday that it was, hey, bring your phones out, take pictures on the floor, on the court, all that kind of stuff. Go ahead and let's get that out of the way. So that was part of yesterday. Today was a little bit more like what he wanted to be was 75% business, 25% fun. So you could tell they're a little bit more locked in. Now, granted, our press availability was before practice today. Yesterday was after practice. So we got a chance to see the vibe before the guys were actually going out onto the floor. But their practice today was unlike any other because they let fans in for free. And there were several thousand fans, you know, across all the teams, even just not even fans of the four teams that are actually here. I saw people wearing, like, Marquette T-shirts and things like that.
Hey, they booked the flights. They booked the flights optimistically.
Clearly, like, you know what, we're still going to go. But they also had the NC State band was performing. All this was taking place during practice. Like, media, we were allowed to be courtside. I was standing right there baseline during warm-ups for NC State today. But you could tell, even with all that stuff going on around them, on the court, in that area, they're 100% locked in.
You know, it's interesting. I saw a quote. We have the clip of Fletcher Lawyer from Purdue saying that they're trying to treat it like any other game. You're in the middle of the circus. You're baseline during practice. Is it possible to treat it like any other game? Because the circus around it and everything has to make it feel different.
It does. And this is unlike anything that these guys really have ever experienced before. I understand the mentality of treating it like every other game in terms of like how you approach on the floor in terms of, you know, we still got to execute what we do, offense, defensively, game plan, all those kinds of things. You know, we can blah, blah, blah regarding that. But in terms of everything else, I mean, I actually remember I was walked by Jayden Taylor yesterday. This is after our locker room availability. We got to talk to players, and he was getting taken like two other places. Like, man, they got you running around everywhere. He said something I couldn't say. But, you know, it's like, man, you know it. It's just, he kind of like, man, they really are getting us around to all these different places, whether they're talking with CNN, whether they're talking with CBS, TNT, SiriusXM, all these other different outlets want to talk to everybody as much as possible. So, yeah, it's a little bit more than treating it like any other game outside of the game itself. But when it comes to the game itself, yeah, you still got to execute and go do like you would. It was the Elite Eight or Sweet 16.
I just don't see, like, a mid-January game against Florida State. It just, you don't have that. You know what I mean?
It's not the same.
Exactly.
It's not the same.
It's not. Dennis Cox, our very own from 99.9 The Fan, out in Phoenix for the Final Four, talking with us on the Heister Automotive Group hotline. Can you compare and contrast the two teams based on their approach? Like, when you're in the locker room, is it different, or, you know, is there's something to be said for every like 19 to 23 year old kind of being similar, but is there a difference that stands out to you between the two teams getting ready?
I would say this. I'm a little bit more slanted, I guess, when it comes to NC State because having been around the team multiple times throughout the season, so I kind of understand who they are as a team and as individuals with some of them. So I would say they were themselves. The Purdue locker room when I went in there yesterday was very much like, we're here to do business, we're here to do work, we're here to take care of business, but also here to prove people wrong because we got knocked out by a 16 seed in Fairleigh Dickinson last year. We feel like we're supposed to be in this place. We have something to prove. Whereas NC State, they still have that mindset of, no, we still have something to prove. Like, yeah, we've won 9 straight to get here. That doesn't mean we're guaranteed to win 10 and 11. You know, that's the thing. So they still have that chip on their shoulder. I know Casey Morcell was actually asked earlier today about, like, do you embrace the, like, underdog mentality? He's like, no, we're just doing our thing. Like, we're just being us. You know, not, you know, buying into, like, the underdog type things. Like, It's like, we get the national story, we get it, but we're just out here to be us. And I think this is kind of the vibe that they've had really this entire season. It's like, you know what, we're just going to try and be ourselves. But yeah, Purdue's locker room was a little bit more buttoned up, it felt like, yesterday.
It does. There's something funny about the fact that the two teams that have very much taken on the everybody doubts us are the two one seeds. Like Purdue and UConn are, you know, all this disrespect. Alabama and NC State, who are the lower seeds and maybe have a better argument for it, seem to just be like in their own bubble playing basketball.
Yeah, it's amazing how like a reigning champion who's a one seed is quote unquote disrespected. I was like, no, like you're the betting favorite by everybody, and a lot of people, including your bracket, mm-hmm. the pick to win the whole thing.
Yep.
I'm like, I don't see where it's disrespect comes in. It's like the Kansas City Chiefs are being like, yeah, people doubted us. Like, no, they didn't.
Or Zach Edey, like nobody wanted me when he went to one of the best prep schools in the country, and he's 7'4".
You're the Big Ten Player of the Year, and all. I'm like no. Like, people wanted you. It's not like, you know, these guys were walk-ons, mm-hmm. and all of a sudden you're making this run. But, you know, like, Purdue, people are catching flack, or they're going to catch a little flack because of what happened last year.
Fairly
no different
Dickinson.
Than Virginia in 2019 when they lost to UMBC the year before. Mm-hmm. It's like, yeah, but you still lost that game last year, and then they found their redemption story to Virginia and won a national championship. So maybe Purdue's walking down that same path 5 years later. But nah, yeah, the quote unquote disrespect, I don't know. I don't see it.
By the way, that UMBC drop may be a little tease for the coach we have coming up next here in a couple minutes.
That's right.
You know what day it is. It's Friday. We do bold predictions. We'll put you on the spot here.
Oh.
Give us a bold prediction for the state Purdue game.
Oh, real bold prediction.
Real bold. And Graham, feel free to give him the buzzer or the bell if you want to.
Mohamed Diarra blocks Zach Edey twice.
Ooh. I like that. And how many times, this is like the flip side of that coin, how many times does he get called for a foul trying to block Zach Edey?
Oh, probably three.
Okay. All right.
That's three. Let's
that's
be honest here.
He doesn't. Mo Diarra does not back down, and I respect that about him.
Yeah.
Dennis, we appreciate it. We'll maybe check back in with you later in the show.
Absolutely.
Cool. Dennis Cox, follow him on Twitter at TheFanRookie. He is out in Phoenix. You can also follow 99.9 The Fan on Twitter and everything else. Our contingent out there will be posting throughout the weekend, which is a good way for you to see all the behind the scenes. You would have known that there's video games in the locker room for state. You would have known everything about that practice, that kind of walkthrough practice that Dennis was passing along. You would have already gotten those visuals. So we encourage you to follow on 99.9 The Fan. Also, I've been told we are knocking on the door of 10,000 YouTube followers, and I would really like to use this weekend of excitement to catapult ourselves over 10,000 subscribers on YouTube. So if you have not yet done so to subscribe to our channel, please do so now. 99.9 The Fan on YouTube, and tell your friends. We crank out a ton of content to our YouTube channel, and we'd really like you to be a part of that community. We have a couple minutes here. So, and by the way, this was planned for the caller earlier. NC State women versus South Carolina. I need to emphasize two things. One, South Carolina is very good. I have some stats to prove it. Two, Sanaya Rivers and Isaiah James are going to have to play really well to overcome the odds. I need to emphasize South Carolina is 36-0 this season. They've won their games by an average of 30 points, 29.6 points. They've had a win of 82 points and a win of 70 points. These are video game numbers. They have an All-American center in the 6'7 Camila Cardoso. They've gotten 38.8 points per game off the bench in the tournament. Their coach is making jokes at the podium. There's a lot to like about South Carolina. Sanaya Rivers and Isaiah James have to lead the way for NC State against South Carolina for the simple fact of that's how every upset happens, right? It's so rare to have an upset of a number one, you know, legendary team without someone being the centerpiece, right? You need to have the great player, right? You need to have the centerpiece, I guess, would be the only way to say it. The person that goes above and beyond. And if you're just playing the odds, more likely to go above and beyond, Rivers and James. One of them, I mean, it might be a Rivers triple-double. It might be seven or eight threes from James. It might be someone else stepping up. But if they pull it off, I think there's going to be an individual somewhere on the way that that really is the person that becomes the star, the DJ Burns or the Gordon Hayward or the Fred Van Vliet, whoever the you know that person is. The Drive with Tim Donnelly, 99.9 The Fan. I think we might be getting another coach here on the line quickly. Graham's giving me the hold on finger, the one finger. Yep, do we have him now? Is that what I'm being told? All right, cool. Ryan Odom, VCU head coach, joining us on the Heister Automotive Group hotline. Coach, thank you very much for joining us. I mean, I think we have to start here. We just had a conversation where somebody off the rip referenced UMBC beating UVA. You're obviously the coach there. Or we're the coach there, I should say. Let's start there. How difficult is it to get to your team locked in when they become America's team? Because obviously NC State, for different reasons, is kind of falling into that category.
Yeah, no question. I mean, it's easier said than done. You know, certainly for us, that was a historic win, first ever. And immediately, you know, you could sense it in the locker room, you know, with the media coming in there and just kind of what we were up against, you know, to try to get ready for that next game. We didn't walk out of the arena that night because it was the last game of the night. You know, until like 1 a.m. And in terms of trying to get those guys, you know, settled down and get them ready for that next day to prep for Kansas State was not very easy, quite honestly. And so NC State, you know, they've been going strong, you know, since, you know, the ACC tournament. And Coach Keats and his staff have done an awesome job. And every one that you win, you know, it just builds confidence for that next one. And I think that's what you're seeing with that team right now.
How quickly does someone from administration or how quickly does someone immediately get in your face and say, we have to use this to raise funds or we have to use this to recruit? And like as a basketball coach, everybody gets into basketball to coach basketball. But how quickly does the business get in your face and say, like, we're the story. Let's capitalize.
Yeah, I mean, I think certainly, you know, it was huge for UMBC, right? You know, one of my mentors was our president at the time, Dr. Freeman Hrabowski, and certainly that moment, you know, was huge for the school overall. You know, he had spent the better part of 30 years trying to build that institution, great academic institution, public school. And, you know, he just done such a great job. And to all of a sudden have sports become, you know, a part of that story for him and to get the message out about all the cool things that were going on our campus and that he had done, you know, that was really rewarding for me personally because I know how hard he had worked for 30 years, you know, to get it to that point.
We're talking with Ryan Odom, head coach at VCU. Coach, is there some secret coaching back channels when you're facing something you've never faced before that you go to, like a back page of the playbook? Because DJ Burns and Zach Edey, like, I can't imagine, you know, there's
this is
even
gonna be fascinating, right?
And you can't simulate it in practice, right? You can't give somebody, like, a, you know, 245-pound plates and a beach ball and say you're going to play DJ Burns today at practice. How do you go about scouting for guys who you've just never seen before?
Yeah, I mean, you just do your best, right? You try to figure out, you know, some times within the season where other teams have had success against that person, right, or that team. And you try to see if you can replicate it. And certainly, you know, we've always tried to do that. I mean, that's part of the game plan is just getting your guys ready, you know, from a personnel standpoint. But those two guys are so unique and, you know, that, you know, you really can't, you can't do much until, like, you can't prepare your team for the size, you know, and the skill that those two guys have. You can't have your scout team do it, right? You just don't have that guy. And it's a really unique situation. And so you just do your best to stick with your principles. You know, how do you guard a post player, you know, in general? How do you keep them off balance? One of the biggest things that you really try to do is just limit the easy ones and make them have to beat you with really hard, difficult plays. And again, that's easier said than done when they're that big and they can get close to the rim.
You know, we all are college basketball junkies. You see the old videos of like when you're getting ready to play Ralph Sampson, an assistant coach, which is Edey, right? So You have the assistant coach with the broomstick. Do you go that far to simulate somebody?
Yeah,
you do.
No doubt. And you do a lot of it through video, quite honestly. It's hammering home with video and clips of things where teams have success against them. And then you show them where teams have lack of success, right? If you do this, you're going to be in trouble. The ball's going to be going the other direction on you. If you do this, all right, he's going to be dunking the ball right near the basket. And so you just got to try to limit it. And, I think most coaches in basketball and certainly in the NBA, there's so much video out there nowadays, you're hammering home. Because you don't have long practice times this time of year. You're in the gym for 45 minutes on the court. But you can't wear them out. They have to be ready for the game. And so really a lot of the prep is done through film.
I don't know if you saw this, but Brad Underwood of Illinois was quoted in a in-game interview talking about Donovan Klingon, the center for UConn, saying, if he blocks 100 shots, he's going to block 100 shots, basically saying they're not afraid of him and they're going to drive towards him. And I don't know if he got to 100, but it felt like it. While watching the game, it was close. How do you balance that where, you have a big, you have somebody that's a defensive presence, and you want to make sure your players are confident, but you also don't want to bash your head against the wall and just go like, hey, keep doing it. You're just as good as he is, even if you might be losing that battle.
Yeah, I mean, they're a tough matchup for anybody right now. I haven't seen many teams roll through the tournament like UConn has over the last 2 years. We were fortunate enough to be in the same conference at Utah State with San Diego State last year, and I know how good they were over the course of the season. And for them to play, UConn fairly tough, but then, kind of for them to separate like they did, says a lot about Coach Hurley and his team. And I think they're doing it again. They're going to be a tough out, in this Final Four. They just have a really good balance of inside and outside play. He's an excellent coach and puts his guys in the proper positions. But to your point, you've got to limit, the amount of times where, like, if somebody's good at blocking shots, well, you don't want to keep going in there after them. You got to find other ways, right? You got to screen them, you got to move them, and find other ways to score.
Coach, last one for you, and thank you very much for taking the time to jump on the phone lines with us. It's kind of, 2020 hindsight. Everyone now likes to say, NC State, because they're this year's double-digit seed making a run, they have that thing, right? Oh, they have this quality. And we can all say that now, but you brought up, you saw San Diego State up close before they go on a run. You saw Duquesne a couple times this year late in the season, and then they make a run. Is there that gut feeling when you see a team saying, like, all right, they may not have put it all together in the regular season, but they're close?
The key is, as a coach, you want your team certainly to reach its potential, and you want them to be playing their best basketball at the end of the season. And I think certainly that's what's happened with NC State. And like I said earlier, one game, all right, one game can lead to another positive game for you. And then all of a sudden you're gaining confidence as you go. And I think that's certainly happened, with NC State's team. Coach Keats has done a great job with that group. They know who they are. They know how they have to win and how they have to play in order to win on offense and defense. They're not going to beat themselves. They're not going to throw it away. They're going to get a shot each time. And at key moments, they know where the ball is going and who's going to make the decision. And that's really what coaching is. The players have to make the plays, but you have to put them in the right positions for them to be able to make the right plays.
Coach, thank you very much for your time, and good luck at VCU.
Awesome. Thank you.
Once again, that is Ryan Odom, head coach, VCU men's basketball. Also, his place in March Madness lore is written in ink. He was the coach at UMBC when they took down UVA as the first 16 seed to ever pull off the 16 over a 1 seed upset. We're going to take a quick break. When we come back, football at 4. The Panthers didn't understand that this is a basketball day, and they actually made some pretty big news. We'll tell you about it next.
Hey, Dennis Cox here with my friends over at Underdog Sportsbook. I know this is the perfect time of year to get involved when it comes to college basketball and sports betting, or maybe an NBA, Major League Baseball. That's where Underdog Sportsbook comes in for you as a sports fan, because they give you a clean, simple sportsbook app using their own technology that gives you a fresh experience with straightforward language that's easy to follow. That's one of the reasons why I use Underdog Sportsbook, is because it's simple and easy to follow. I know exactly where to go. I know exactly what I'm looking at. I know exactly what I'm betting, what I'm doing, the parlays, what I'm doing, the prop bets, all those kinds of things. And unfortunately, I'm not in North Carolina to use it, because you have to be in North Carolina to use Underdog Sportsbook, because they're the only state that has it. Download the Underdog Sportsbook app on iOS or Android. Sign up with the promo code Dennis and use your first bet mulligan, which returns up to $1,000 as bonus funds if your first bet loses. That's Underdog Sportsbook, promo code Dennis. Must be 21 plus to gamble and present in North Carolina. Gambling problem? Call 1-877-718-5543 or visit morethanagame.nc.gov or call 1-800-GAMBLER. Terms, conditions, and restrictions apply and can be found in the Underdog Sportsbook app.
Bama, UConn, NC State, Purdue.
And the next stop on the Purdue Redemption Tour is the Final Four.
And the Wolfpack back to college basketball's promised land.
The Final Four will be heard here. 99.9 The Fan, the Triangle Sports Leader. Final Four coverage from Phoenix is built by Mungo Homes, building homes and dream teams for 70 years.
Sanja loves to bake, but her feet,
they were throbbing.
Then one day,
I found a solution. Arch Supports from the Good Feet store.
Have foot pain? Good Feet could help.
You too can live the life you love with Arch Supports from the Good Feet store.
It's bow time. Something new just dropped at Bojangles. Take the bold taste of a crispy golden chicken supreme that's been seasoned to perfection, then add dill pickles, Carolina Gold barbecue sauce, and a toasted bun that's great on the go. What do you get? You get a Bose Bird Dog. In fact, you can grab two of them for $5. So when you're on the go, headed to practice, or need a snack, grab a Bose Bird Dog. Hurry in before they're gone. Available for a limited time. It's bow time.
There's no time like bow time, but sometimes it's go time. No time to stop. Introducing Bojangles' new Bird Dog, a seasoned to perfection Bojangles Chicken Supreme, dill pickles, Carolina Gold barbecue sauce, all on a toasted bun. Great on the go. Try two Bird Dogs for just $5 or a two Bird Dog combo for just $8. Hurry, Bo's Bird Dogs are available for a limited time only. When you're hungry for flavor and value, it's Bo time.
What are you doing?
I'm training for the new Ultimate Dash Scratch-Offs. I could get a chance to dash through a warehouse full of prizes.
That explains the shopping cart.
Plus, I could win up to $2 million in cash.
And that explains the tuxedo.
I'm chafing.
Feel the rush with new Ultimate Dash Scratch-Offs from the North Carolina Education Lottery. Must be 18 to play. Approximate overall odds of winning are 1 in 3.78. Problem gambling helpline, 877-718-5543.
A happy place comes in many colors. Whatever your color, bring happiness home with Serta Pro Painters and make your happy place your home. Serta Pro Painters, that's painting happy. During our spring sales event, get 10% off any home painting project, $2,500 or more, when you schedule before April 30th. Get started today at CertaPro.com. Each CertaPro Painters business is independently owned and operated. Home improvement contractor registration numbers are available at CertaPro.com.
Contractors, when you're trying to stay competitive, every dollar counts. Consider Habitat for Humanity for your new cabinets and kitchen design services. Habitat for Humanity Restores now sells brand new solid wood cabinets, high quality and manufactured locally, available in multiple styles and color options. Everybody wins because you save money and can stay competitive, which keeps your customers happy and sales benefit Habitat for Humanity home projects. Learn more about custom cabinet orders from Triangle Restores at trianglerestores.org.
The IRS is the most powerful collection agency on earth, and if you owe back taxes, the news isn't good. The IRS is raising the interest rate it charges on unpaid taxes, and further rate hikes are expected. Most people don't know it, but the IRS adds interest charges on your tax debt daily. So if you owe the IRS today, you will owe even more tomorrow. And it doesn't stop until you get right with the IRS. The good news is, getting right can start with one phone call to Optima Tax Relief, America's number one tax relief firm. Optima's tax professionals specialize in the Fresh Start Initiative, a powerful IRS program that can save you thousands if you qualify. In fact, the experts at Optima Tax have resolved over $1 billion in tax debt for their clients. Call now for a free consultation.
Call 800-970-3199. That's 800-970-3199. 800-970-3199.
Optima Tax Relief.
Some restrictions apply. For complete details, please visit OptimaTaxRelief.com.
This hour on the Triangle Sports Leader is brought to you by the Ritchie Law Firm Injury Lawyers.
You can feel the madness!
Go to GotBryan.com. That's GotBryan.com.
WCMC HD1 Holly Springs. Take us with you on radio, web, app, Alexa, and YouTube. 99.9 The Fan, the Triangle Sports Leader.
Weather. I'm WRAL meteorologist Elizabeth Gardner. Nice afternoon out there, partly cloudy skies, just a bit breezy, a northwest wind gusting 20 to 25 miles per hour, a high of 61 degrees. Come on out to WRAL TV from noon to 6:30 today. We are turning the gardens red in celebration of the NC State Wolfpack. Temperatures tonight will be cold, mid-30s to near 40. We do have a frost advisory in effect. And then for tomorrow and Sunday, we'll see partly cloudy skies and highs in the low to mid-60s.
Weather update brought to you by Newcomb & Company, where your comfort is their business. Visit NewcombandCompany.com. 4 o'clock check of your money. The Dow Jones is up 307 points at 38,904. Market update brought to you by Sanford's 150th birthday bash tomorrow from 10:30 a.m. to 4. This is a free event happening at Sanford Fairgrounds. Get all the details at Sanford150.com.
Let's move the chains. Time for Football at 4.
The Drive with Tim Donnelly, 99.9 The Fan. In about 15 minutes, we're going to be hearing from Clark Kellogg, CBS college basketball analyst, who you've seen on a lot of the coverage of the NCAA tournament. In the meantime, though, couldn't somebody tell the Panthers this was a basketball weekend? The NFL is just trying to claim every weekend on the entire calendar, huh? The draft is in what, like 18 days or 21 days? You couldn't just wait? Couldn't wait a week? They went and gave Derrick Brown, their stud young defensive tackle, the bag. $96 million extension over 4 years, and the money everybody cares about, the guaranteed money, $63.165 million guaranteed for Derrick Brown per an ESPN source.
Well, Dan Morgan said that he wanted dogs when he first got introduced.
Bingo!
He's a young player, and Tim, he seems like a dog.
He backed up their words. He said, we want dogs. Signed a dog. Derrick Brown is one of the better interior defensive linemen, but he does, like, he's a run stuffer. He is a guy that ends plays with a bit of anger. He is a large fellow. There is something to be said for them not being all talk. So far that, like, maybe one day they'll learn, and when I say they, I mean the Dungeons & Dragons duo, D&D, Dan and Dave, Dan Morgan and Dave Canales, the new GM and head coach. Maybe one day they'll learn that they're not under oath at the podium, but thus far, just about everything they've said, they've done. And what I mean by that is Dave Canales says, hey, guess what? One of my advantages is I don't have an emotional connection to any of these guys. What happened shortly after that? Dante Jackson, get out of here. Hayden Hurst, get out of here. Von Bell, get out of here. Right? Dan Morgan says, I want some dogs. Brings in a couple of guys that Evero had worked with on defense prior, and now they lock up Derrick Brown. By the way, he's tied for fourth highest paid defensive tackle in the league with Quinnen Williams at $24 million per year. But it might be even more impressive than that. The three guys that are more per year, Chris Jones, Christian Wilkins, and Justin Matabuke, they're all higher paid, but they were all true free agents. They could go test the market if they wanted to, had much more leverage. Derrick Brown, there's still a year left on his deal, plus they could have franchise tagged him, so they didn't have nearly the urgency to get a deal done with him that those others had to get done. They were all true free agents. So it's a big, big cash money deal for Derrick Brown. But do you know what else it shows? It shows that Dave and Dave, or Dave and Dan, the D&D duo.
Dungeons and Dragons.
Dungeons and Dragons are still, they're legitimately evaluating. Right?
And they're committed.
For at least they're committed to Derrick Brown. I was a little concerned that they were like, you ready for a wild reference? This reference, I don't know why it popped into my head. I have not watched this show in a long time. Have you ever watched How I Met Your Mother?
Yes.
There's a episode, I believe, where they talk about what stuff can you keep that your ex gave you, right? Like, you can't keep their hoodie, but, like, what if they bought you a lamp? Could you keep a lamp? And some were arguing, like, anything your ex got you has to go, right? Your new significant other shouldn't have to, you know, click on the light of what your ex got you. And for a while, it felt like Dave and Dan were that way. Like, anything Scott Fitterer brought in gots to go, other than Bryce. If it's not Bryce, you gots to go. And then they were just going to methodically move on from everybody. This tells me, no, actually, they are looking at individual cases and deciding which ones they like and which ones they don't. Right? They are. It's not just they moved on from Hayden Hurst because they didn't like Hayden Hurst. It's not just that they moved on from Hayden Hurst because Hayden Hurst was signed by the previous guy, and just like a lamp that you got from your ex, you got to get it the heck out of the house. It's they moved on from him because they evaluated it and didn't like the way he fit into their future. And the way I know that is because they just signed Derrick Brown. They could have said Derrick Brown was chosen by somebody else. Get him out of here. Trade him for whatever we can get for him, which you could argue they did with Brian Burns, right? They could have given a giant near top of the market, top four, top five, like they did for Derrick Brown at the position deal to Brian Burns. They chose not to. They chose to move him. This Derrick Brown deal tells us, well, they didn't just move Brian Burns because he's not their guy. They moved Brian Burns because they did the evaluation. He was going to be too expensive for the value he brought, or whatever it is. So you know, I'm, again, maybe one day they'll learn they're not under oath at the podium. But until I catch them, you know, leading us astray or throwing up a smoke screen, it seems like what Dan Morgan and Dave Canales tell us they're going to do, they then go do. I'm not sure that's the best way to conduct business, right? If you become known as like the super duper honest group. Because then you're like, no, you know what? I don't think we're going to trade the first our second round pick, the first pick of the second round. Everyone in the league is going to go, all right, they're not trading.
Yeah.
Sometimes you want to, or maybe the opposite, right? We are going to trade it just so everybody thinks there's not somebody you love at that spot, and then you can take them. Sometimes a well-placed smokescreen helps. I don't know if they're capable of it, to be honest with you. Dave Canales, you ask him a question, he's like, yeah, I'll tell you the answer. It's ready for another wild reference. Anytime Graham's doing the show, we have to have some wild movie references. In one of the Austin Powers, Will Ferrell plays a character who can't not answer a question if you ask him three times. If you ask the question three times, he has to answer. That's kind of Dave Canales. It's like, are you going to sign Derrick Brown? I'm not telling you. Are you going to sign Derrick Brown? I'm not telling you. Are you going to sign Derrick Brown? Yes, we are. $63.165 million guaranteed. Oh, we're being told that there's some change-ups in the schedule. We're going to call an audible and go to one of the premier faces of March Madness, Clark Kellogg, CBS college basketball analyst, longtime NBA player, former college basketball great as well. Clark, thank you for taking the time to jump on the line.
Tim, great to hang out with you, man. This is a special weekend on the sports calendar across all of basketball, men's and women's, so I'm glad to be able to join you.
We'll start with, you know, you talk about one of the premier matchups. It's being talked about like it's Batman versus Superman around here. Edie versus Burns, who has the upper hand?
Well, Edie, clearly. I mean, he's 3 bills and 7'3", so clearly that gives him an advantage. My late dad always told me, good big will beat good little anytime everything is equal, and as big as DJ is, he's not as big as Zach. But that doesn't mean that he's going to be overwhelmed or outmatched. Mm. I think he's just got to be cerebral in his attack, and he's shown that he's got great basketball savvy and IQ. I just don't know if he can back down Zach Edey like he's able to back down most defenders that are on him. And we'll see if Purdue even plays Zach on him. I would think that would be the matchup, but they've got other guys they might put on DJ Burns Jr. I think he's going to have to use his face-up jump shot a little more in this particular matchup. But we'll see. I mean, that's part of the beauty of it. We speculate and postulate and anticipate, and sometimes things are thrown at us that we didn't think about seeing. So we'll see how Kevin Keats and the Wolfpack approach dealing with Big Zach.
Is there someone in basketball history that reminds you of DJ Burns? It seems like he's super unique, but you've seen him and played in a lot of basketball. Is there a name that comes into mind?
I hadn't really thought about it, but because he's so big and has such a soft touch and is nimble-footed, there are guys, maybe Glenn Davis, who played at LSU and played in the NBA for a while, Big Baby Davis. He shot it a little. He shot threes on occasion, but had that same type of girth and light-footedness, you know. I'm trying to think. Zach Randolph, because he's left-handed, Zach was never quite that big, but had a similar type of touch and game, you know, from 15 feet in, where you wonder how Zach got his shots off over bigger, stronger defenders as regularly as he did with such effectiveness. So I see some of that in DJ Burns Jr. too, his ability to make shots against tough defense using his body, his touch, and his footwork.
Clark Kellogg, CBS college basketball analyst, joining us on the Heister Automotive Group hotline here on The Drive. Clark, when it comes to Edey, I mean, there's a reason why every award has him on the short list, and he's won a bunch of them. Mm-hmm. How much do the refs play a factor in it? You look at the discrepancy between Tennessee and Purdue in the last round. It was drastic. Yeah. And then I'm not – like, you know, certain refs call a game tighter. Could that affect the way that those two play down low?
I actually love the way the games have been officiated, and I've watched a ton of them throughout the tournament. They've allowed some latitude with physicality, and Zach is a hard guy to officiate, much like Shaq was in his day. Yao Ming, any of those guys that are really talented and big, you don't want to call it differently because they're bigger. You want to be fair across the board, but it's a hard dynamic. But I think the officials have gotten it right more times than not. Zach puts a lot of pressure. I actually think, you know, if you're looking at percentages, they call most of the fouls they could call in favor of Zach, but there's probably still another 10 to 15% that they don't. And I don't have a problem with that because I think it works that way for other players too. All physical contact isn't a foul. And so I've been really pleased with overall how the officials have called the games, given some room for physicality and allowing rhythm and flow to be part of what that is, because you could stagnate games if you were only going to officiate by the letter of the law as opposed to the spirit of the law in contact.
If you're running NC State's defense, are you like the sharpshooters from Purdue? I think are a little underrated because everyone's eye goes right to Edey.
Yeah.
Are you sending the double knowing that those shooters are going to be available? Like, how do you balance that?
I'm mixing it up. Mm. I don't want a steady diet. I mean, obviously you want to try to make Zach work for whatever he gets. You don't want to create easy shots for the perimeter guys, although the Purdue guys haven't shot it great from the three-point line in the tournament, but their percentages are pretty impressive when you look at their body of work. So, yeah, I would mix it up, Tim. You know, double him some, double him from different places. I think more important than how you defend Zach in terms of doubling or not is being disruptive at the point of attack. Really good ball pressure, trying to deny passing angles, and then trying to create deflections as much as you can, tracing that ball on passes as much as you can before it gets in there. I think that's a huge component if you're going to be effective. And then get in there and dig it out when Jack puts it on the ground if you can.
I could talk like basketball nerd stuff with you all day and dive into the rotations and everything. But the fact is, March Madness comes with a bit of magic, right? Here in the Triangle in North Carolina, there's a lot of feels like 83 being thrown around and a lot of the similarities. How do you account for that element of what NC State's done? You know, going into a game where you might want to say Purdue has this advantage, Purdue has that advantage, Purdue has this player, that player. But on the other side, there's that other thing. There's that whatever NC State has going on. How do you account for that?
Well, I think you acknowledge it, you respect it, you appreciate it, and you don't dismiss it. Mm. And it is a factor. And if things are tight and guys are playing at the level they've shown or even beyond for NC State, which could happen, then you could have another magical, unexpected miracle moment. And you never discount or dismiss those in sports.
We're talking with Clark Kellogg, CBS College basketball analyst. Clark, just a few more for you. I was listening to Tom Izzo speak recently, and you know he's one of the legendary can take a team on a run in March Madness above seeding. And he said he thinks of it in winning weekends rather than winning games. So he might be looking ahead to the game that is on the other side of their pod, who it could be, you know, on a Wednesday, just to get that extra leg up on the second game if they make it happen. Looking at that Alabama-UConn game, is UConn beatable? Like, is there a path towards getting those guys knocked out either by Alabama or whoever comes out of the other side?
Yeah, clearly. I mean, you have to be at your very best. Alabama has three-point shooting prowess that no other team really has in the tournament to that level. And they've shown better defensive efficiency in this tournament. So the three-point shot plus defense that they've shown gives them a chance. You've got to stay close, though. You can't allow UConn to separate. And because they can score the way they can, the Crimson Tide might be able to make that happen. If it gets to a Monday night and it's Purdue or NC State, same thing. I mean, Purdue obviously would match up in the middle much better because of Zach, and they've got other pieces around them. But any team that's here could be playing on Monday, although I think it will be Purdue and UConn.
Clark, I appreciate you for taking the time. You keep Chuck and everybody in check out there, all right? Keep that NBA foolishness and you keep the college basketball for us, okay?
Well, we have a good time with each other, and I love being part of the team with those guys, and we're going to do the same thing we've done for the last several years together.
And we're going to keep enjoying it. Thanks for your time.
Thank you. Thanks, Tim.
Once again, Clark Kellogg, CBS College basketball analyst. And snuck in there, he does think it's going to be UConn and Purdue, which, you know, that's the betting favorites there, right? Those are the guys those are the teams that everybody's on. But he also acknowledged there is magic in March, which, you know, we know which side that tilts. The Drive with Tim Donnelly, 99.9 The Fan. We'll take a break when we come back. We do have to get into what happened on the Canes ice last night and maybe another check-in with our friend Dennis Cox. Stick around.
Dennis Cox here with my friends over at the Law Tigers. I'm excited about today because this day I've been anticipating for a long time, because this is the day that the custom Hurricanes 2023 Harley-Davidson Softail Motorcycle is going to be given away, because the Law Tigers, Tobacco Road Harley-Davidson, Shiny Side Paint, and your Carolina Hurricanes, they all teamed up to give the ultimate Canes fan a custom Hurricanes 2023 Harley-Davidson Softail Motorcycle. Almost 37,000 of you signed up for this bike, and it's going to be given away today. Law Tigers, North Carolina's motorcycle lawyers. Law Tigers is a network of independent law firms who are members of the American Association of Motorcycle Injury Lawyers. Law Tigers is not a law firm.
Get crazy, Canes fans. It's hockey night in Carolina.
He scores! Dmitri Orlov picks the corner, and the Canes take a 2-1 lead.
Storm Watch with Adam Gold at 6:30. Puck drop. At 7.
Second chance, they score! Jesper Fast knocks it home!
On your exclusive home for the Carolina Hurricanes, 99.9 The Fan.
The moment we've been waiting for has arrived. Download the Caesars Sportsbook app today using code NEWNCBG. Then place your first bet of $5 or more. Win or lose, you'll receive $150 in bonus bets. Open to new users in North Carolina who are 21 or older. Terms and conditions apply. See Caesars.com/promos or the promos tab in the app for full terms. Gambling problem? Call 1-877-718-5543 or visit morethanagamenc.gov. Tribal Casino Gaming Enterprise is a licensed operator by the North Carolina State Lottery Commission.
See if you're a winner every night. Watch live lottery drawings on WRAL-TV's 11 o'clock news. That's right, Carolina Pick 3, Carolina Pick 4, and Carolina Cash 5 numbers every night on WRAL-TV's 11 o'clock news. See if you're a winner before you go off to bed. Get your lottery numbers live every night.
Go Education Lottery.
Only on WRAL-TV's 11 o'clock news.
At WakeMed MyCare 365, we deliver convenience others only talk about. Every day of the year. Primary care and urgent care under one roof. Multiple locations, virtual visits, walk-in or schedule an appointment online. From annual physicals and routine care to sinus infection, strep, or the flu, we couldn't be more convenient. Learn more about our kind of care and our kind of convenience at wakemed.org.
Imagine waking up this time next week and being 100% debt-free. No credit cards, no car loan, no personal loan. Hey, it's Dennis Cox. Loan Pronto's Equity Express line of credit can make it happen. Homeowners are turning their home equity into cash almost instantly. With Loan Pronto's AI-based system, you can get approval in about 10 minutes. With almost no documentation, no appraisal, and no hassle, you can get hundreds of thousands of dollars out of your home. Use that money to pay off all your other loans. The average homeowner saves over $850 a month doing this. Listen, your home value is way up. You can use that to wipe out all those credit cards, get some money for a home improvement. Literally hundreds of thousands are at your fingertips, and approval is just minutes away. Call 919-381-1760, 919-381-1760, loanpronto.com, 919-381-1760, NMLS 1661781, subject to lender approval, equal housing lender.
Direct Auto Insurance is for uncompromisers, the people who refuse to make trade-offs in life. Like Kelly, when her old car insurance got so expensive that she couldn't afford to drive anymore, do you think she started carrying her groceries for miles? No, but she did find Direct Auto's savings that allowed her to drive instead of compromise. With savings of up to 25%, you too can stop compromising and keep driving. Get a quote today at directauto.com. Savings based on applied discounts and will vary. Terms apply. How you buy can affect price. National General Group, Winston.
Now, during Staples Print Big Sale, get $20 off your print purchase of $100 or more, $50 off your print purchase of $200 or more, and $100 off your print purchase of $300 or more. So the more you print at Staples, the more you save. To demonstrate, print, print, print at Staples, you save, save, save. But if you print, 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 print at Staples, you save, 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 save. See how that works? Staples Print Big Sale. Print more, save more. Up to $100. Ends 4/6. Visit staples.com/print for details.
I lock up my Old Spice Fiji aluminum-free dry spray to keep that 24/7 lasting freshness safe for myself. Fresh coconuts, palm trees in the wind. It's like catching waves in Fiji. Actually, I just talked myself into a refreshing spritz of Fiji. My Old Spice is missing! No!
The Drive with Tim Donnelly, 99.9 The Fan. We'll be opening up the phone lines again shortly. Heistra Automotive Group Hotline for your final thoughts, your final questions and feelings going into the Final Four. So be ready for that, 919-860-5326. In the meantime, we're bringing back on our producer traditionally, Dennis Cox. He's out at in Phoenix covering the Final Four. Dennis, thanks for jumping back on. We were just talking with Clark Kellogg. And yeah. he snuck in there under the wire, you know. I do think it's going to be Purdue against UConn. Which I wanted to get you back on to kind of get a temperature on that. Do you get the feeling that everybody is kind of expecting at this point in the tournament that the favorites are going to kind of make sense of everything?
Well, yeah, I think so. I mean, Purdue's the favorite, and understandably so. They're one seed for a reason. It's a reason why they've got to this point. There's a reason why. If you look at the tournament up until this point, that's why NC State, when you look at seed number, is the complete outlier because we had all number ones and number twos get to the Sweet 16, which rarely ever happens. So, yeah, the favorites are Purdue and the favorites are UConn. You know, UConn went and did it last year as a four seed. They're a one seed this year. And, yeah, Purdue definitely – Zach Edey is the difference maker. The guy hasn't scored less than 20 points since February 4th. So it's literally been 2 months or over 2 months since the guy didn't score at least 20 points.
The other thing that popped out at that Clark Kellogg conversation is, you know, around here I think we're very familiar with DJ Burns finding a way, right? Yeah. And that's how it's been for the last nine games. Clark was a nice little cold glass of water to the face on like, oh, no, he's not going to push around Edey. He's not going to move him off his spot. is DJ Horn ready, or do you get a sense of someone else? You know, they have to have some second gun or second scorer ready. Are they ready to be the one they lean on if DJ Burns is bottled up a bit by the taller Edie?
I think so. Talking with the players, it's never been about any one guy, you know, for them. It's not like if this one guy isn't cooking or these two guys aren't going, everything else falls apart. We've seen Ben Middlebrooks have big games. We've seen DJ Horn have plenty of big games. Mike O'Connell, heck, had some of those most double-digit scoring games are actually back in the ACC tournament. I think he had four straight games of double-digit points where he only had three the entire regular season. So it's been different guys at different points throughout this whole run for NC State. So they even said it yesterday. It's never been about one guy. It's about the team as a whole. And if it's DJ Burns that's cooking, they're going to feed him. If it's DJ Horn, they're going to let that guy go as well. So it's never been about one guy for that group. And it seems like, again, the vibe in the locker room is that everyone's ready. Mm-hmm. Everyone's ready knowing that their number might be called and they all feel like they're ready to step up when their moment's called. But also you can feel the trust in each other as well. Like if it's Jayden Taylor off the bench, they trust that guy. If it's Breon Pass has got to come in late and handle the ball, they trust that guy. It's the trust from top to bottom across this team is pretty remarkable.
How much have they embraced the feels like 83 moment? I have to imagine they're being asked about that team constantly. You know, it's not going to go anywhere, but they can either embrace it or kind of strike out on their own. How much have they – where are they on that spectrum?
So Keats actually was asked about this yesterday, and he said they've embraced it because they had the 83 team and the 74 team on campus at some point during this season. So they've had those guys already there. So there's a connection already between those past championship teams from 74 and 83 to this team that's there right now. And then they get guys from that team that have been reaching out to both players and to Keats as well, you know, wishing them good luck and all those things. And they feel like a tight bond with those guys that won championships in the past for NC State. So that connection, it's real. Like, it's a real thing. It's not like, hey, I played back on the team back in the day. Good luck this weekend. Those guys know each other on a personal level, and you can get the sense that they are embracing that mentality.
Dennis, we appreciate you for jumping on, and we'll keep leaning on you to track down interviews for us.
Absolutely. Thank you. Also, big thanks, obviously, to Westwood One for allowing us to be here on Radio Row, sponsored by Wrangler. It's Wrangler season out there, open roads, endless horizons. Shop Wrangler.com for new denim styles made for your next adventure. Wrangler, for the ride of life.
There you go. Taking care of the business. That's Dennis Cox, our producer out there in Phoenix, bringing us the insight on the Heister Automotive Group hotline. We will be hearing later on in this hour from Andy Katz, digital reporter, analyst, and host covering the NCAA tournament. So that'll be coming up in just a few minutes. Quickly, though, Canes, the heck was that? That first 15 minutes. Oh, never mind. No Andy Katz, by the way. We're playing... playing it by ear here.
Omaha.
There we go. It's for those of you that aren't in the radio world, these events, the Final Four, the Super Bowl, those types of things, there's always going to be those changes. But that just gives me more time to ask this question maybe two or three times. Canes, the heck was that? The first 15 minutes yesterday.
Not good.
Against Boston. Did you have 4 days off or did you have 4 months off? That's kind of my question. The it looked like a game that was lost because you were rusty, because you hadn't played in a while, because maybe you completely checked off and truly unplugged in those four days. But it took you a full period to get back into like professional hockey. And by that point the game was over, right? You'd given up the 3 goals and you know, Boston is a good enough team. They're just not going to let you decide to get back in the game. Here's Rod Brindamore after the game about that sluggish start.
Yeah, I mean, a couple things. I mean, they made good plays, give them credit. And then, but I think we were sluggish to start. We weren't ready for that pace. And that's kind of, you know, I think that's on me. Just knowing that the way we took these last 4 days was more mentally getting away, and we weren't ready to get to it. I mean, you know, after the first, it was probably a fairly even game, but the game's pretty much over.
Yeah, exactly. After the first, it was a pretty even game, but the game's pretty much over. Context is important there, because guess what Boston is doing once they're up 3-0? They're going to play a little bit more conservatively, right?
Like, part of the bus.
If you play evenly with a team that's up 3-0, they don't see it as playing evenly. They see it as them finishing out a victory.
I mean, I hate to say it, that game sort of felt like it was over before it even started. With the goal 20 seconds in?
I'll put it this way. My son wanted to play. He just had his birthday. He got one of those carpets that has roads on it, so yeah, the little Hot Wheels can drive on it. He wanted to do that. I was like, I got to watch the game. Canes haven't played in a while. About 10 minutes into the game, I was like, you know what? Crank out the Hot Wheels. Let's play. We'll leave the game on TV, but we're not going to watch it. We're going to be down here going.
We'll have it on as background noise.
Exactly. And to be quite honest, that's what it should have been used for, right? If you needed to take a nap, put the Canes game on last night. If there is good news, I guess Rod Brind'Amour came out of it still pleased with Freddie Anderson, who did give up some goals, but played a fairly good game. Here's Brind'Amour on Freddie.
You know, gave us a chance anyway, kept us in there. Freddie made some good saves tonight too, kept us in there. It's kind of unfortunate on the first one, really. He makes a save and gets kicked in. You know, that's kind of how the night went really at the start. So, but he was good, but the rest of our game wasn't really great.
Freddie's been really good since coming back.
Fortunately, suffers his first loss.
First loss, get it out of the way.
Yeah.
Right? It's now you don't have to worry
4-1
about it.
4-1 loss in the regular season is better than a 4-1 loss in game one or game two of the first round of the playoffs.
And really, the defensive effort in front of him, every goalie is going to say, I can stop them all. But the defensive effort in front of him put him in a tough situation on a couple of those early goals. So I'm not – if there is something positive, it's that Rod, and I would throw myself in there as not super disappointed with the way Freddie Anderson played, especially with how well he's been playing this year. He's pretty darn good. The interesting part is looking at the season long, because now you fall 4 points behind Boston in the race in the East, and you're tied with Florida. Obviously, they're both in the other division, so we're talking about Eastern Conference Finals possible matchups here. But I'm wondering if with that gap and a little bit different of a kind of hierarchy in the Eastern Conference, if the Canes don't stop worrying about maybe home ice because there's teams above them that are less likely to be caught, and start just kind of, for lack of a better term, ramping down and ramping up, like – giving guys rests. Maybe we see Morrow. Maybe we see D'Angelo. Maybe we see Kotkaniemi in there. Not because those players are going to be in any kind of a, intended playoff lineup, but just to get guys that will be in the intended playoff lineup a day off here or there. You want to be playing well. As we saw, you don't want to be rusty. But at the same time, you want to make sure everybody's healthy and fresh leg going into the postseason. And maybe a loss is a little bit of a blessing in disguise because it gives them the comfort to look at these next six games as just preparation for the postseason rather than some kind of chase for home ice. I don't know. I'm stretching here. The fact of the matter is this. I've been saying it since, 3 weeks before the season. Nothing the Canes do in the regular season can render this year a success or a failure. They are to the point in their build where the postseason is the only thing that matters.
Yep.
It's where the Buffalo Bills are. It's like there are certain teams you've accomplished everything in the regular season that you possibly can already. You've been the division leader. You've been top two in goals allowed. You've been so many things in the regular season. And you've had success in the postseason, but you haven't achieved the ultimate goals. So these next six games, you want to win a President's Trophy? You want to go on a hot tear to make sure you have home ice in the Eastern Conference Finals if you face the Panthers? I'm looking at it and saying these next six games do very little to prove anything about this team that I don't already know. I know they can be a great regular season team. I know they can be a wildly successful statistical regular season team. What I need to know now, and the only way their season has proved a success, is if they translate that success into being a wildly successful and statistically relevant postseason team.
Yeah.
So the next six games, I mean, we're going to track the standings because that's what we do. We're going to track the points because that's what we do. But I also think we need to understand that it's about figuring out the way you want to use this roster in the postseason. That's Rod Brindamore's number one, and it's figuring out which players are going to play well in the postseason. That's what it is, and that's what it's going to be. The Drive with Tim Donnelly, 99.9 The Fan. We're going to take a break. When we come back, more Final Four talk. Let's open up the phone lines. 919-860-5326. Heister Automotive Group Hotline. Today is your last day to get your opinions on the air before the Final Four. Women tonight for NC State, men tomorrow. Heister Automotive Group Hotline is open for your thoughts. 919-860-5326. How does NC State win? Will they win? We want it all. Again, 919-860-5326 coming up next.
Dennis Cox here with my friends over at Underdog Sportsbook. As you all know, sports betting is alive and thriving in the state of North Carolina. But maybe you're actually traveling out of town this weekend to maybe watch, you know, one of your favorite teams play. Well, guess what? You got to play in the state of North Carolina with Underdog Sportsbook because they're the only state that actually has Underdog Sportsbook, which makes North Carolina so special. And here's something that Underdog Sportsbook gives you. A simple, easy-to-use sportsbook app. Using their own technology, something that's fresh, simple, and easy for use as the sports fan. So before you head out of town this weekend to watch your favorite team play, make sure you use Underdog Sportsbook. Download the Underdog Sportsbook app on iOS or Android. Sign up with the promo code Dennis and use your first bet mulligan, which returns up to $1,000 as bonus funds if your first bet loses. That's Underdog Sportsbook. Promo code Dennis. Must be 21 plus and present in North Carolina. Gambling problem? Call 1-877-718-5543 or visit morethanagame.nc.gov or call 1-800-GAMBLER. Terms, conditions, and restrictions apply and can be found in the Underdog Sportsbook app.
What are you doing?
I'm training for the new Ultimate Dash Scratch-Offs. I could get a chance to dash through a warehouse full of prizes.
That explains the shopping cart.
Plus, I could win up to $2 million in cash.
And that explains the tuxedo.
I'm chafing.
Feel the rush with new Ultimate Dash Scratch-Offs from the North Carolina Education Lottery. Must be 18 to play. Approximate overall odds of winning are 1 in 3.78. Problem gambling helpline, 877-718-5543.
Now is the time to switch to Spectrum. Get Spectrum Internet delivering fast and reliable speeds for just $49.99 a month. Plus free advanced Wi-Fi for enhanced security and a free Spectrum Mobile Unlimited line with nationwide 5G. Ask how you can get a Visa Rewards card up to $500 when you add more mobile lines. Internet, advanced Wi-Fi, and mobile. Get it all with Spectrum One. Go to Spectrum.com for full details. Offer subject to change. Valid for qualified residential customers only. Restrictions apply.
It's bow time. Something new just dropped at Bojangles. Take the bold taste of a crispy golden chicken supreme that's been seasoned to perfection, then add dill pickles, Carolina Gold barbecue sauce, and a toasted bun that's great on the go. What do you get? You get a Bo's Bird Dog. In fact, you can grab two of them for $5. So when you're on the go, headed to practice, or need a snack, grab a Bo's Bird Dog. Hurry in before they're gone. Available for a limited time. It's bow time.
There's no time like bow time, but sometimes it's go time. No time to stop. Introducing Bojangles' new Bird Dog, a seasoned to perfection Bojangles Chicken Supreme, dill pickles, Carolina Gold barbecue sauce, all on a toasted bun. Great on the go. Try two Bird Dogs for just $5 or a two Bird Dog combo for just $8. Hurry, Bo's Bird Dogs are available for limited time only. When you're hungry for flavor and value, it's bow time.
Welcome to Sweetbriar in Durham by Mungo Homes. Sweetbriar is where location, lifestyle, and luxury meet just 10 minutes from shopping at Briar Creek. In this amenity-rich neighborhood, which will include a pool with lazy river, a huge fire pit, outdoor fitness and playground options, and dog parks, there's a new home designed for you whether it's your first home or your last. Most anything you need to access in the Triangle is a 20-minute commute. Go to Mungo.com today to learn more about Sweetbriar in Durham. Mungo.com.
QC Kinetics announces the arrival of National Medical Director Dr. Mitchell Sheinkamp, an acclaimed orthopedic surgeon with two decades of experience and extensive research in regenerative medicine.
But I was one of the first orthopedic surgeons to do it. And at the same time, I integrated clinical research that's resulted in several publications that are really directing the future of regenerative medicine. I was drawn to QC Kinetics after I reviewed their protocols, and everything they were doing is consistent with my own approach.
Today, Dr. Sheinkamp leads the entire team of medical professionals at QC Kinetics, taking this exciting medical breakthrough to a whole new level.
What we are doing at QC Kinetics is transforming lives.
Get lasting joy.
joint pain relief. Call QC Kinetics now for your free consultation.
This is the future of medicine.
Call QC Kinetics, 919-400-5473. That's 919-400-5473. In Cary, Clayton, Raleigh, and Wake Forest, 919-400-5473.
Hey, I got a question for you. You hate bending over to put on your shoes? Wish you should just put them on standing or sitting without ever having to touch them? If so, then I have the shoe for you. Introducing new hands-free Skechers Slip-ins. With new Skechers Slip-ins, you just step in and off you go. You don't even need to lace up. So how do Skechers Slip-ins work? Well, there's a special smooth comfort pillow in the heel that helps your foot slide right into place. So just step in them and go. Find new hands-free Skechers Slip-ins for the whole family at a Skechers store, Skechers.com, or wherever stylish footwear is sold.
The Drive with Tim Donnelly, 99.9 The Fan. Phone lines are open for your last final words. We have about another hour and 15 minutes of The Drive here on 99.9 The Fan. That's about how much time you have to get your thoughts on the Final Four for NC State onto the air. 919-860-5326. That's 919-860-5326. In the meantime, let's play a little bold predictions. How do we feel about that? Bold predictions coming on up.
Another audible. Hold on. It's a coming.
That's the voice of Graham Hill, our producer for today.
Adobe's crashed on me because there's been so much stuff going. All right, hold on. Here we go.
We're just waiting for music at this point just so we have some vibes. It's a Friday. We need some vibes. We need some chill music. There we go.
Not really chill, a little more hype.
Yeah, that's fine. And energy is energy. So the way this works is I'm going to make a prediction that I think is bold, and then Graham will either give me the bold enough bell, which is always a horn with Graham, or the not bold enough buzzer. There you go. And if I get the not bold enough buzzer, I will have to make it more bold in real time on the air. This is an all NC State men's and women's Final Four edition of Bold Predictions. So they are all involving either the men's or women's run to the Final Four. I'll get it started. I'm just going to put the pressure on Graham right here.
Oh, gosh.
Because this is, if you say this is bold, some people might get upset. If you say this isn't bold, some people might get upset. NC State wins. I'm talking the men here. You're thinking that's a bold prediction. Some State fans might get mad at that and say, why is it bold? All right, no. I've already got it locked in. You think NC State?
My mind hurts.
It would be a bold prediction for them to just win the game. How about this for a bold prediction? Ooh, I just apologize to this microphone. I just spit a little bit. DJ Burns outscores Zach Edey. Think hard. Not bold enough. Zach Edey is averaging like 100 points a game. Coming off a 40 burger against
DJ Burns had a career high against Duke with like 27.
Edey had 40.
So what? All right, whatever.
DJ Burns outscores Zach Edey. And how do I make this more bold? And DJ Burns, I can't go. I'll go DJ Burns outscores Zach Edey and Mo Diarra out-rebounds Zach Edey. Somehow these bold predictions are just going to turn into like NC State dominates and wins by 500.
Because wouldn't that be great for Wolfpack fans?
It would be fantastic for Wolfpack fans. It's just, you know, even if they win, I don't think these are going to be coming true. I guess that's why they call them bold.
All right, to be fair, I got to lock in. My brain's kind of mush right now with all the behind-the-scenes tactics. I feel like an offensive coordinator in the radio booth with Tim Donnelly down the field getting all these
guests. Well, you need to be the voice of calm.
All right, here we go.
The offensive coordinator is always supposed to be the voice of calm. Let's go to the women's side of things. Sanaya Rivers, 20-plus versus South Carolina tonight. No, wow. A lot of faith in Sanaya. What about...
She's going against her former team. She's going to want to show out.
She is, we're about to talk about that in a second here. 20-plus points. We'll go at least 25 and 5. 20 points, 5 rebounds, 5 assists at least. 20 plus 6 and 6 at least. 27 and 7? This is on 28 and 8. Are we combining Rivers and James? I think so. You brought it up. Sanaya Rivers is a former South Carolina Gamecock. And up until now, up until today, which we've heard, everybody has very much been saying and doing the right things, right? Dawn Staley and Rivers, it's, you know, they still communicate. They send happy birthday texts. They send texts after big wins. They're still close. I don't know if you can be a Division I athlete the level of Rivers and not hold some kind of grudge. As much as you are professional about it and cordial about it, like when you committed to South Carolina, you probably wanted to be Cardoso, or you wanted to be one of the legends. And now you're at NC State turning in your own legendary career, a different legendary career. But, you know, there's something to be said for wanting to win the breakup, right? There's something to be said for wanting to show everybody what they could have had. So I think she's gonna be out there doing her thing. NC State women beat South Carolina. That one's also bold. You want to know, by ESPN's matchup predictor, the men's team is less likely to win than the women's team. Women's team is up against a legendary South Carolina squad, and they're like an 18% to win. The men are down near 10.
A buddy of mine texted me an interesting hypothetical.
Okay.
He said, what do you think NC State fans would rather want? The women's team to win the national championship or the men's team to come running up in the national championship?
I think you count rings. I think you count rings. I think any situation where it involves a national championship, you ask for the national championship. On the, like, if the other option doesn't also involve a national championship, I think you count rings. The fact of the matter is, and I say this completely understanding you want more.
Yeah.
The men's season is such an overwhelming success already.
Fair.
I don't know if making it to the final and losing gives you that much more buzz than making it to the Final Four and losing. Don't get me wrong, winning a national championship, there's significantly more than losing in either game. But they're already the story of the tournament. They're already going to be like 20% of one shining moment. They're already going to be able to capitalize that and hang a banner. I'm not sure what one more game would do. And also, as I said, you count rings. If the women can get a ring, you take that over anything involving not getting a ring. All right, let's go back to the men's. This is a gut feeling. Every year in the Final Four, there's a quote-unquote role player, right? Maybe not one of the stories of the first couple of weekends, who catches fire, right? Does a couple good things, and suddenly their smiling face is like on pictures, on posters. I think Casey Morsell has 4+3s.
Four plus.
So four or more. Think hard. All right. He's a really good shooter. At times this year, it hasn't shown. He hasn't always been in rhythm. He is a really good shooter. And it's different shooting in a football arena.
Yeah.
It's different. The area behind the bucket, it's the depth perception. I just have it's a gut feeling, right? Sometimes you just got to play off your instincts. It's a gut feeling that he's going to hit one early. Maybe they throw it into DJ Burns and Edie is swallowing him up and he kicks it out. And it's a swing pass. And I think Morsell catches it almost with so much space that it's like, I have to shoot this. And he goes in.
Shout out to Dennis Cox. He actually asked Fletcher Lohr that in the locker room. And of course, Fletcher was just like, nah.
Took a couple shots to get used to it. He said, top of the key, it is a little bit different. It's going to take a couple shots to get used to it in warm-ups, but he didn't play it up as a big deal.
But also, to your point, yes, Casey Morsell is a good shooter. He can knock down some crucial shots. I just feel like in a game like this, his presence is going to be needed more on the defensive side. Like when you're talking about double-teaming Zach Edey, I see Casey Morsell being one of those two guys.
That's why I'm saying, like, early in the game, he gets a look where he's so open he has to shoot it, right? It's a rotation.
Yeah.
It's a broken play. He's lost, and it's on a wing. He has the ball. No one's within 7 feet of him, and it's like, all right, I'm going to shoot it, and then it goes in. And then, okay, well, I made one. Let me see if I can make – oh, I made two. okay, maybe I'm the guy today. I think he makes four or five of them.
I could also see a situation where Purdue's starting to establish a run, and then right on the other side, NC State pushes the ball up in transition, like three, four passes. He's in the corner. Bang.
He hunts for dunks in those situations, too. When there's a run or when he senses the moment is there, he hunts for dunks, which is you don't expect from him. He likes to put down those old two-handed dunks. Last one here, Modiar double-double. There we go. I just think he's a walking double-double at this point. Modiar is pretty good. The Drive with Tim Donnelly, 99.9 The Fan. Coming up next, we have our starting five, but we're going to make it Final Four specific here. Five most important people in the NC State-Purdue matchup. We rank them as part of the starting five coming up next.
Dennis Cox here for my friends over at Deep River Sporting Clays and Shooting School. Check them out online, deepriversportingclays.com. We all know wedding season's approaching. It gets warmer. A lot of people are getting married, but you want to have fun for your last bachelor or bachelorette party. You want to end with a bang? Head to Deep River Sporting Clays and Shooting School. Everything that they have to offer for you, to not only for your round of clays, but if you want to have that pick under their pavilions and maybe even enjoy the outdoor fire pit, go to deepriversportingclays.com. Again, deepriversportingclays.com. Check out all they have to offer. Book your appointment today, deepriversportingclays.com.
NC State, Purdue, Bama, UConn.
The first Final Four ticket is punched by the defending national champions, UConn.
And the Alabama Crimson Tide will roll into the Final Four.
The Final Four will be heard here. 99.9 The Fan, the Triangle Sports Leader. Final Four coverage from Phoenix is built by Mungo Homes, building homes and dream teams for 70 years.
Hey, hey, what do you say? John Forsland here for my friends at Buffalo Brothers. What a great time for sports. The College Hoops Tournament in hockey is in the home stretch. I call games in Seattle and around the country, but when I'm back in the Triangle, I head right to Buffalo Brothers. Make sure you visit Buffalo Brothers for all the big games. Always great specials, like half-price appetizers, Monday through Friday, 4:30 to 6. Dine in, carry out at all five Triangle locations and online at buffbrothers.com. Aw, man, now I want wings.
Our state. State's future begins with our students. That's why the North Carolina Education Lottery has contributed over $10 billion to education. Through scholarships, school construction, support staff, and pre-K programs, lottery dollars move our state forward, helping students become the best versions of themselves. Visit movingncstudentsforward.com and share how your student or school community has benefited for a chance to earn $2,000 for your story. Must be 18 to play. Problem gambling helpline, 877-718-5543.
Hey friends, Paul Ihander from 99.9 The Fan for my team at FanDuel. And I want you to say goodbye to busted brackets, because FanDuel lets you bet on every game of the tournament. Whether you're betting on a big upset or a one seed, it's time to go dancing with America's number one sports book. You can bet on everything from the money line, pick those winners, to over-unders, to which team cuts down the nets. All on an app that's safe, secure, and super easy to use. So take the court with $200 in bonus bets, win or lose, when you place your first $5 bet. Just visit FanDuel.com/Paul, Paul with a capital P, and get started. FanDuel, America's number one sportsbook. 21 plus and present in North Carolina. First online real money wager only. $10 deposit required. Bonus issued as non-withdrawable bonus bets that expire 7 days after receipt. Restrictions apply. See full terms at FanDuel.com/sportsbook. Gambling problem? Call 877-718-5543 or visit morethanagame.nc.gov.
He's one of those kids that only laughs at real anger. I don't know if you've ever met one of those peaches, but see, most 2 and 3 year olds, they laugh at manufactured anger. You can go up to a kid that age and just go, rawr, and they're like, and this kid's like, mm-mm. I want to see your blood pressure spike, man.
From his multiple Netflix specials, comedian Tom Segura brings his new tour, Come Together, to PNC Arena Raleigh, April 14th. Tickets on sale now at Ticketmaster.com.
Were you forced to get a nosebleed mortgage rate in the past year? Loan Pronto is here to rescue you. Hey, it's Dennis Cox. Listen, if your mortgage rate is over 7, you're going to be in heaven with Loan Pronto's zero-cost refi. You can cut your house payment by hundreds of dollars with zero closing costs. Rates have come down, so you could say goodbye to that bad loan you got stuck with. Loan Pronto's now got APRs with fixed rates in the fives. One couple just did this and saved over $550 a month with no appraisal and closed in 10 days. So, Don't live with that stupid rate a day longer. You can lock in at a lower rate now with no costs and very little paperwork. Loan Pronto, your easy button for lower rates and no closing cost loans. Call now and see how much lower you can get your house payment. Refi now and you can even skip your next two house payments altogether. 919-381-1760. 919-381-1760. LoanPronto.com. 919-381-1760. NMLS 166-1781. Subject to lender approval. Equal housing lender.
Charlie did not die from an overdose. Charlie was poisoned.
No other family should go through this. It's just horrific.
Go to safe.pharmacy. Use the free tool. Learn if the online pharmacy you're using is safe.
This hour on the Triangle Sports Leader is brought to you by the Ritchie Law Firm Injury Lawyers.
You can feel the madness!
Go to gotbryan.com. That's gotbryan.com.
WCMC HD1 Holly Springs. Take us with you on radio, web, app, Alexa, and YouTube. 99.9 The Fan, the Triangle Sports Leader.
I'm WREL meteorologist Amy Wilmoth. A pretty start to the weekend today. Lots of sunshine and some mild temperatures. It's going to be chilly tonight, though. We have a frost advisory in effect. We'll get down to 36 in the Triangle. And then Saturday afternoon, partly cloudy with a high of 61.
Weather update brought to you by Newcomb & Company, where your comfort is their business. Visit NewcombandCompany.com. 5 o'clock check of your money. The Dow Jones closes the day up 307 points at 38,904. Market update brought to you by Sanford's 150th birthday bash tomorrow from 10:30 to 4. This is a free event happening at Sanford Fairgrounds. Get all the details at Sanford150.com.
It's 5 o'clock. Time to serve up the biggest sports stories of the day. Here comes your starting five.
The starting five here on The Drive with Tim Donnelly on 99.9 The Fan. Today we're mixing it up. We could do the starting five biggest stories in sports like we normally do, but there is a biggest story in sports, and that is, in the Triangle at least, the NC State men's basketball team making it to the Final Four. An 11 seed on that kind of run, a 10 seed in their own conference tournament on that kind of run. I think we have to honor that and give it this for the starting five. The five most important people in the NC State-Purdue matchup. Could be anyone, right? Let's run it. Number five. Michael O'Connell. And here's why. He handles the ball a lot. And deciding who gets the ball and when for NC State in this game, I think takes on a bigger role. And obviously some of it is designed by, you know, the sets they run and the different, you know, screens they set and everything else and what the coaching staff does. But there is an element of, like, if Burns has position, you have to get him the ball. Because who knows how many times he's going to have position in this game with Edie down there. If there's a hot shooter, you have to take advantage of that every single time. And O'Connell has been the guy kind of making a lot of those decisions. Here's O'Connell talking to the media earlier this week on becoming more serious as the game gets closer and they move on from some of the fun of Final Four week.
Pretty much like he described, it's, you know, you want to have fun while you're here. It's definitely business, but you also want to enjoy the moment. And then yesterday was a little more fun. Today is more a little locked in where we had, we'll have practice here, you know, make sure we're on the court, taking everything serious, getting, you know, live game reps up, getting live game shots, because you want to be ready for tomorrow when you have to take a big time shot or even just a normal shot and make sure you can, you know, knock it down.
Obviously ready for the shot, right? And
like a Virginia one?
I was going to say, Michael O'Connell being like, you have to be ready for a big shot is like, okay, great. Yeah, Robert Horry says the same thing. But I think also part of it is recognizing that in a game like, you know, any game really, it could be the one big shot you need, or it could be like the 10 just good decisions on consecutive possessions.
Yeah.
Right? It could be you catch the ball with 5 seconds left. You got to drive the length of the floor and shoot a bank three to force overtime. Or it could be you have to read the defense appropriately. You have to find a way to get the ball to DJ Burns when he's in deep with position on a defender who he can beat, and so much more. So that's where I think O'Connell comes into play.
One more time.
Hey Graham, your microphone's on, bud. Graham is talking to one of our behind the scenes MVPs, our video guy Joe, and
offensive coordinator. Some offensive coordinator talk going on in the booth.
I have a funny story on that, and we'll tell it super quickly. There's in the NFL, they have the in helmet. Good thing you weren't saying any bad words. They have the in helmet radios for the quarterbacks. So this happens apparently a lot in the NFL, but I have one from college. One of my very, very good friends, to this day, he's a really good friend, had too many concussions on our college football team, so he had to stop playing. But he stayed on as a student assistant. So that meant he got to wear the headsets when our offense had the ball because he was signaling in plays. And when I was quarterback, he would come over and relay what some of the coaches were saying about me into the headsets. And there was one, it's the ultimate, like, no. Yes, right? Made a bad read, threw it into double coverage. And apparently why the ball was in the air, coach was using every bad word he possibly could against me and didn't know that, like, his microphone was on and all of the coaches could hear it. And, you know, he thought he was just talking to one coach, but he was talking to them all. So my buddy heard it, and then he caught it and immediately flipped on a dime, right? Just a great play by the wide receiver. Very bad throw. And it went from, you bleeping, bleeping, Timmy bleeping, 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 to, like, good play. All right, on the ball. Here's what we need. We need doubles right.
See, I may be a youngin' in the industry, folks, but at least I know that you always treat the mic as if it's hot.
That lessons learned the hard way by a lot of people.
That was just a prime example right there.
By a lot of people. That's number five. Let's get to number four.
We are the Four Horsemen.
This is a combo, okay? We're counting down the five most important people in the NC State-Purdue matchup. I took one. Actually, I lied. I took two kind of cop-outs, two loopholes. This is a hyphen. This is Braden Smith / Fletcher Lawyer. They are the shooters that are going to have to keep NC State honest. Both average double figures. They are the 40-plus percentage shooters. They're the guys who, if NC State decides to sell out to stop Edie, if they decide to double-team every time he touches it, if they decide to have Mo Diarra guarding him and send help every single time Edie gets it, he's going to kick it out. Those are the two that are going to have to knock down shots.
Yep.
Which means NC State has to judge as early as they can whether they're knocking them down or not.
Who's hot, who's cold.
Because if those two go cold, that gives you a lot more flexibility to send more creative double teams towards Edie and make his life a very difficult life. If they're knocking them down, then you have to look at Diarra and Middlebrooks and say, you're on an island. You have to take the player of the year. You have to take the All-American. You have to take that guy and find a way to do it yourself because we can't afford to leave these others open. So Smith and Lawyer making or missing threes becomes very, very important. So I know they're two guys, but I'm counting them as one guy because they kind of play the same role.
Oh, sorry. I just got a very important email from somebody in the office, and I was like, oh, gosh.
Was it?
No, it was actually somebody congratulating us for how well Pat Therapy's doing.
Look at
we
that.
Have hit
pat yourself on the
magnificent
back.
Numbers over the past month.
By the way, check out the Pat Therapy podcast. Found everywhere podcasts can be found. Let's hear from Fletcher Lawyer, one of the players that is number four. He was talking about doing everything they can to treat this game, this final four game, just like it's any old regular basketball game.
It's win or go home, so you got to treat it like a basketball game. It's not a show. It's a game. And I think us being locked in, getting our feel for the court, but ultimately knowing it's still 10-foot rim, same amount of length out there.
It's not a show. It's a game. Yes. Facts. With it. Here for it. Very hard to do. Easy to say, hard to do. We talked with Dennis Cox earlier today, and we're going to check in with him one more time before the end of the show. He is out in Phoenix at the Final Four. He said the practices were open to the public. Thousands of fans in there watching practice.
Not even all NC State fans. Some Marquette fans,
just
some
people,
Alabama.
College basketball UConn, yeah. Fans. And to sit around and say, like, oh, we're going to treat this like any other game, it's not. Right, I think it's better to acknowledge that it's not and address it. It's, you know, I'll tell a personal story that mixes in with something Coach Keats did.
Okay.
So Coach Keats at practice, I think it was 2 days ago or yesterday, it was the first time he let players bring their phone to practice.
Yep.
And he said, take pictures on the court, right? It says there's a big logo that says Final Four, right? Take pictures. Get you and your buddies together and snap some photos and FaceTime your parents and all of those things.
There's a bunch of toughies all over a football stadium, and it's not for a bowl game.
Like take it in. Sometimes I think it's smarter to do that than it is to, hey, we're going to treat this just like every other game. No phones. We're out here to practice. We're going to work hard. We're going to run. It's like, well, it's not the same. You don't understand, Coach. And the personal story I'll equate it to is I grew up in Hawaii. There's a school called Kamehameha, which is, this is not an exaggeration. It might be situated on billion-dollar land. Okay, the views from this school are some of the best in the entire state of Hawaii, which goes to say they are some of the best views in the world. Just massive cliffs and Pacific blue water.
Wow, way to rub it in, Tim.
I'm telling you, like no, that I am 100% selling it right now. And their football stadium has big stands on one side and the other side, a chain link fence, a cliff, and expansive views. It is unreal. Our coaches would, that was the away team. I didn't go to Kamehameha. Our coaches would get us there like 3 hours early and give us an hour the first time we played there every year to go look. And if you wanted to take pictures, if you had a camera phone, this was kind of when those were new, a little old. You could go and you'd look down and you'd go, whoa, and you'd look at the view and you'd go, whoa. Just so in a game, you're not doing that, right? Just so when it's third down, you're not caught looking over the edge going, whoa. So sometimes it is better to acknowledge like that field isn't normal. That view isn't normal. The Final Four isn't normal, right? You can't do what you did against Syracuse in December and expect that same mental preparation to get you ready for you're going to have tens of millions of people watching you and all of your hopes and dreams rest on this game.
But it's still tied all back in. I love the analogy that Coach Keats has been using. I'm sure you do too. We're both fans of analogies. Mm-hmm. When you go to the hotel desk, they ask, are you here for business or are you here for pleasure? And Kevin Keats told his team to say both.
Yep.
50-50 yesterday, their first practice at State Farm Stadium, 50% fun, 50% business. That's when they got to take pictures yesterday on the court. Today, 75% business, 25% fun. And then tomorrow is all in. Black shades, black leather jackets as you're walking in. Boombox, playing the pump-up song. And let's get ready to rock and roll.
There's a lot of time for fun after a win. But there's a lot of time for fun this week also. That's number four. Let's get to number three.
One, two, three.
We are counting down the five most important people in the NC State-Purdue matchup. Number three, DJ Horn.
The hometown hero.
NC State needs two legitimate scores, and that's in case one of them gets bottled up. There is, and this is where I think DJ Horn comes in. DJ Horn is the most, I believe, kind of defiant of the NC State Wolfpack. He is the first one, at least to my knowledge, I believe he did it during the NCAA or the ACC tournament. He's the first one to say, why not us?
Right? Yeah, he coined the term.
Which is... like, that is a bit defiant, right? Why not us? Like, instead of everyone asking you, like, oh, why? What do you have to do? What do you? He's turning around to everybody else and going, why not us? He's the one that has a little bit of that edge, and I think they're going to need a little bit of that. I think it's important that NC State recognizes there is a difference between being celebrated and being believed in. Right now, everybody is celebrating what they've done, right? Everybody loves the story. They love the dramatic Cinderella. Everybody is celebrating that they made the Final Four and then picking Purdue, right? There's a difference between being celebrated and being believed in. Know that difference, right? Understand, oh, you're being nice to my face. Thank you. Oh, yeah, thank you for the congratulations. Yeah, it's been a wild ride. We've really enjoyed it. Yep, and then as soon as they turn around, they're saying, yeah, I think Purdue by 12. Like, understand that's happening and be prepared to prove people wrong.
It reminds me of what DJ Burns said after NC State defeated Duke, and a reporter asked, you know, how'd it feel to have, you know, Carolina fans, Virginia fans, you know, other teams
chanting
in the ACC
chanting for you.
And DJ Burns was like, well, we know they actually weren't cheering for us. They were just cheering for Duke to lose. Like, yes, keep that same energy.
Yeah,
it's us against the world.
It is. And we're seeing UConn and Purdue both make those arguments, right? Purdue was saying nobody believed in us. So you're a one seed, right? NC State still, I think, has people questioning, right? There's the whole, oh, March is wacky. That's how they end up here. If I'm them, I'm out to prove nothing wacky happened, right? How many wins consecutively does it take before, you know, we were just a good team that put it together at the right time, rather than some wacky aberration of team, oh, how crazy was this?
So like my dad said yesterday, you can make the argument that NC State might not be one of the best four teams remaining in the tournament, but guess what?
Well, they're one of the best four
teams
remaining.
They're one of the best four teams remaining in the tournament.
There's only four, so at worst, they're fourth. And if you say they're fourth, they should take that as an insult. The other thing about like DJ Horn is legitimately, all this entire run, they've built inside out, right? It's been at times, a lot of times Burns, at times Diarra, occasionally Middlebrooks, kind of being the scorers that start everything, and then everything else comes off of it, right?
Yeah,
they
down
score
low.
Down low, the defense collapses, jumpers become available. It might have to be opposite this time, right? You might have to start with the perimeter in order to get Purdue moving, and then you can work it down low. I think DJ Horn is the most likely to be the centerpiece of that perimeter scoring if that's what you have to do. So that's number three. Let's get to number two. Just the two of us. This is the other one that I'm using a little bit of a loophole on. I called for, by the way, we're counting down the five most important people in the NC State-Purdue matchup. I'm combining three people into one person. I'm calling them the ref. Because there's going to be three refs, right? How the refs call this game, I think, is a bigger impact than most are allowing. If Zach Edey and DJ Burns do go full two grizzly bears fighting over a salmon on National Geographic, how many swipes do the refs allow before somebody gets called for a foul? And if Mo Diarra is guarding Zach Edey, Mo Diarra is not as heavy as those two other guys, how much do they let him be physical with Edey before they start calling fouls there?
What happens when an unmovable object meets an unmovable object?
Well, that's on when Burns has the ball. I believe Edey will guard him. When Edey has the ball, I don't think Burns is going to guard him. So how much contact do they allow on that side of the ball becomes very interesting. These two guys are going to be aware of each other. I know they've watched each other on film. Matter of fact, here's Zach Edey saying DJ Burns has been disrespected.
Yeah, I think it's kind of unfair the way people treat him. I think people kind of treat him like he's a sideshow. He's a really good basketball player. Like, don't get that mistaken. And we're gonna give him that respect. And we're gonna treat him like that because he's earned it.
I don't think anyone's treating him like a sideshow, but I get why he would say that.
Spectacle, maybe.
Yeah, like you know, he's different, right? He's different, and people are excited about it. But what I mean when I say the refs are so important is Zach Edey, he draws fouls, man. He draws fouls. And I'm you know, we talked about it with Clark Kellogg earlier today, CBS college basketball analyst, who you see on your TV throughout the tournament. I brought up the foul discrepancy, and he actually said he liked the way it was reffed. Purdue and Tennessee in the Elite Eight. Purdue drew more than twice as many fouls as Tennessee. If there's anything like that discrepancy, I find it near impossible for NC State to win the game. If Purdue is drawing twice as many fouls as NC State is drawing, I think that's about, you know, all she wrote. And so there's you know, I say this all the time. There's two ways to pass somebody in a race, right? Either you speed up or they slow down. Those are the two ways you pass somebody in a race. So for State to finish closer to Purdue in fouls, either they have to draw a lot more fouls than Tennessee did, or they have to commit a lot fewer fouls than Tennessee did. And I'm not sure which one of those is more possible, but I do know how the ref is calling it makes a huge effect on the game. If you let Mo Diarra get physical with Zach Edey, I think you don't have to double as often. If you make Mo Diarra play middle school, hands straight up, shuffling feet side to side defense, I think you do need to send a double team, and that opens up the shooters and gives Purdue everything they want.
I was just going to say, you know how you avoid this altogether? Don't allow Zach Edey's first touch to be inside the lane, like Gary Hahn talked about on Pat Therapy. As soon as he gets his first touch in the lane, it's already halfway over.
And that's what Coach Grant from Boston College said, right? Full court pressure. So just the entire act of getting the ball to Zach Edey is a bit more difficult. You're going to have to use it all. Yeah. Every tool in the tool bag is going to have
the tank.
Is going to have to be used in this one. And through none of those tools can you involve a heavy amount of fouls. That's number two. Let's get to number one. The most important person in the NC State Purdue Final Four matchup is Kevin Keats.
I might get emotional here.
Why?
Just because it's just a beautiful redemption story. I can't wait to see Denzel Washington play Kevin Keats in the Disney movie this in a couple of years.
Denzel or Jamie Foxx. I'm thinking more by the time they make the movie, because you need time for it to fade into memory and then be brought back. I think Denzel.
The kid from Stranger Things.
Denzel's son. I think Denzel's son could be the guy. Kevin Keats has some high-profile decisions. And I really like the way he's coaching. I've said this before. He's coaching with a healthy amount of bleep it, right? He's playing with a healthy amount of there's nothing you can say about me that hasn't been said about me this year, right? I've proven the haters wrong. Some people wanted me to lose my job. It's not even a judgment call. The athletic director, the president, whoever, they didn't have to decide to give me an extension. It was in my contract. If I win the ACC championship, I get an extension. It was in my contract. If I make the Final Four, I get an extension. It was in my contract. If I win games in the tournament, I get this amount of money. It was in my contract. Like, he's playing with, I've already proven myself that, well, what? Like, what now? Right? He's giving me, who's Gladiator? Russell Crowe. He's giving me Russell Crowe in Gladiator. Are you not entertained? Vibes, right?
He's playing with house money.
He's played DJ Burns at points in time this year, I didn't think could play more than 20 minutes a game. He played him 42 minutes in a NCAA tournament game.
There are some NBA players currently that can't even play for that long.
There's only 40 minutes in a game. He played 42 minutes because it went into overtime and he took some overtime minutes. Like, how much does Middlebrooks play? I've seen Middlebrooks score 21 points. The next game, get in foul trouble, play like 10 minutes. That's Kevin Keats, just a healthy amount of bleep it, right? The temptation is if Middlebrooks scores 21, the next game you're like, all right, we got to ride the hot hand. He's like, no, you sit on the bench with me. I've got a feeling here that it's Diarra's day or it's Burns' day. And it was right. Like, Jaden Taylor played in that overtime against Oakland. Now, part of that is because there was some foul outs, but he was in there and he knocked down the big shot, right? Playing these guys at the perfect moments. It's a healthy amount of trusting his instincts. It's a healthy amount of not being afraid of making the wrong decision. Do you push the tempo against Purdue? Do you try to say, we're in better shape, your big guy is in less shape? Do you grind it down a bit and say, like, let's see what happens if we have fewer possessions, right? You foul less if you have fewer possessions. All of these are decisions Kevin Keats is going to have to make. He's probably already made many of them, and he's just waiting to roll them out. But each and every one could change everything.
I wonder if he's going to pull a rabbit out of his hat by bringing in, let's say, an Ernest Ross, a Dennis Parker Jr., a Breon Pass off the bench.
Run zone, right? Like,
full court press, right off the bat. Yeah.
There's so many ways you could, heck,
swipe at the ball.
Move DJ Burns to like the elbow extended and say, we're going to draw, because he has a little bit of a jumper. I wouldn't say he's got a three-point range, although he did hit a three-pointer in the ACC tournament. DJ Burns can go out to 17, 18 feet. Maybe you try to draw Zach Edey away from the bucket, which frees everything else up. I'm not going to pretend to predict what Kevin Keats is going to do, because one of the things he's done in the postseason is be just unpredictable enough, right? He hasn't, by the way, I'm not saying he's, you know, going to roll out all, like, you know, five guys that we aren't used to seeing.
DJ Burns is playing the guard position.
Yeah, we generically know what they're going to do, but he's tweaked just enough a few times that it's been just unpredictable enough that teams haven't been able to settle in against them. So I'm thinking Kevin Keats has something up his sleeve, and we'll see if it works. He's shooting a high percentage over the last nine games, but we'll see. We'll see how he can make it happen. With that being said, we have a message that I want to pass along to you from my friends over at DraftKings, my partners over at DraftKings. The wait is over. DraftKings Sportsbook, an official sports betting partner of NASCAR, is now live in North Carolina. It's been almost a month since you've been able to bet legally on all your favorite sports anytime, anywhere, right here in North Carolina with DraftKings. And for a limited time, new customers who sign up with promo code TIMD, T-I-M-D, and bet $5 will receive $250 instantly in bonus bets. There's a team that we've been talking a lot about today in a particular pretty important tournament that is a 9.5-point underdog. If you think they cover that number, feel free to check it out on DraftKings. DraftKings has the best features, including same-game parlays, player props, and more, with fast and easy payouts right at your fingertips. Download the DraftKings Sportsbook app now using code TIMD. That's T-I-M-D with no spaces. Bet $5 after using promo code TIMD and get $250 instantly in bonus bets. You can use them on the women's tournament as well if you have a feeling over there. Only on DraftKings Sportsbook with code TIMD. The crown is yours. Gambling problem? Call 877-185-543 or visit morethanagame.nc.gov. 21 plus, North Carolina only. Bonus bets expire 168 hours after issuance. Deposit and eligibility restrictions apply. Terms at DraftKings.com/sportsbook/NC. NASCAR is not a sponsor of this promotion and used under license. We need numbers game contestants also. We have on the line, as far as a prize today, a $25 gift card to Salt and Lime in Cary. Salt and Lime, experience the coastal cuisine of Baja California. Always great food using fresh ingredients daily. Fun for the whole family. Visit both Raleigh locations, Falls of Neuse Road and Grove Barton. Also, check them out online at saltandlimecabo.com. If you want to play the numbers game, this is our last one of the week. You need to call in right now, 919-860-5326, 919-860-5326. Numbers game coming up next.
Evan Canty and Michelle are unsportsmanlike.
Nine straight elimination games that they've won, and yet they keep going about their business very workmanlike, and they have this childlike enthusiasm when they're doing it. Like, this is a fun basketball team to watch. They're the most fun team to watch in the men's tournament. The way that they play basketball, especially their intensity on the defensive end, I mean, how could you not root for NC State at this point?
Mornings from 6 to 9 on 99.9 The Fan, the Triangle Sports Leader.
What are you doing?
I'm training for the new Ultimate Dash Scratch-Offs. I could get a chance to dash through a warehouse full of prizes.
That explains the shopping cart.
Plus, I could win up to $2 million in cash.
And that explains the tuxedo.
I'm chafing.
Feel the rush with new Ultimate Dash Scratch-Offs from the North Carolina Education Lottery. Must be 18 to play. Approximate overall odds of winning are 1 in 3.78. Problem gambling helpline, 877-718-5543.
Did you know one of the best investments you can make? It's in yourself. At My Computer Career, in just a few months, you could start your new career in the high-demand, recession-resistant field of information technology. Isn't it time you invest in you and start a career in networking, cybersecurity, AI, or upskill to boost your current IT career? So, get the ROI you deserve at My Computer Career. No experience necessary. Start now at mycomputercareer.edu.
Financial aid is available for qualified students, including the GI Bill.
Having pain like that and not knowing how you caused it and for how long it's lasting, it's debilitating.
QC Kinetics patient Diane Richardson hated not being able to live her life to the fullest due to joint pain. But then she called QC Kinetics, where regenerative treatments helped her pain go away.
The result was phenomenal.
QC Kinetics is the nation's leader in using natural biologics to restore and repair damaged joint tissue.
This was a great alternative for for me as opposed to going in and possibly having surgery or something else. There was no downtime, and that's what I love. My life is too busy for me to be sidelined.
If you're tired of constant pain from arthritis or injury, don't think the old treatments are the only treatments. Discover regenerative medicine at QC Kinetics.
Just to feel good and know that I'm out of pain is the best thing ever. I'm able to do everything that I want to do.
Call QC Kinetics now for your free consultation.
Call QC Kinetics, 919-400-5473. That's 919-400-5473. In Cary, Clayton, Raleigh, and Wake Forest, 919-400-5473.
It's time for the Coastal Scholar Athlete of the Month.
Hello, this is Creighton Blackwell from Coastal Credit Union, here to celebrate our next Scholar Athlete of the Month. We are here at South Garner High School, where we're going to celebrate the next Scholar Athlete, Patience Ifedine.
Patience has been an awesome addition to our women's basketball team. Patience has been playing since her freshman year. So to be a year-round athlete and to have a 3.9 GPA, that takes a lot of dedication and hard work.
I just never forget like why I'm doing the stuff that I'm doing, why I'm a student athlete, and why I play basketball.
And she's a leader, very much a leader on this team, and she plays a very important role in all our lives.
She'll tell you the truth of what you do wrong, but she'll like make it sound nice. She won't try to make it sound mean.
My teammates, they've shown me stuff that I didn't even know about myself, and they push me to be great every day. I mean, obviously I do the same for them. And my coach, she's been everything to me. My mom calls her my godmother, but I don't know about that yet. We'll work on that. But she's been everything to me. She's made me a better person, and she's just grown my game to a whole nother level.
Congratulations, Patience.
Thank you.
For 20 years, 99.9 The Fan and Coastal Credit Union have been recognizing scholar athletes at Triangle Area Schools. If you'd like to nominate a high school athlete, head to WRALSportsFan.com, keyword award.
Mitchell Heating and Cooling, we do the job right every time.
Protect your heating and cooling system like my offensive line protects me. I'm Drake May, quarterback at UNC. Mitchell Heating and Cooling has been committed to your comfort for 50 years and counting. Call Mitchell Heating and Cooling today.
Contact us now at MitchellHVAC.com or 919-556-5069. Train. It's hard to stop a train.
The best solutions every time.
The Drive with Tim Donnelly, 99.9 The Fan. It is time to play the numbers game. The prize, a $25 gift card to Salt and Lime in Cary. Salt and Lime, experience the coastal cuisine of Baja California. Always great food. Using fresh ingredients daily, fun for the whole family. Visit both Raleigh locations, Falls of Noose Road and Grove Barton. Also online at saltandlimecabo.com. The contestants for today, David in Raleigh and Dennis in Wake Forest. As always on a Friday, and I think I have an idea of where these answers might go, but on Friday our question to find out who goes first is always the same. We'll start with David in Raleigh. David, what is the highlight of your upcoming sports weekend? The highlight of the weekend, but it has to be sports related.
A highlight definitely is going to be watching the NC State game. Hopefully they can pull it out and make it to Monday.
There you go. Solid answer. Dennis, same question to you. What's the highlight of your sports weekend?
Well, that was a great answer there by David. So I got to say my kids' lacrosse games.
I respect the answer, and kids' events are always fun, but I think you knew which way this was going.
How much of a coincidence is it that Dennis is involved in a lacrosse game this weekend, or color Dennis?
Yeah, must be a Dennis thing. With that being said, though, David, you get to go first for picking the final four. David, are you there?
Yes, I'm here.
All right, the way this works, you got to pick one of these four categories. They are NFL, Purdue alumni, NFL Arizona State alumni, makes sense with the action in Phoenix. There's an MLB category, obviously Major League Baseball players, and NHL Canes and Whalers only.
We're going to go NFL.
Do you want Purdue alum or Arizona State alum?
Can I draw back on that and just go MLB?
All right, you absolutely can.
Okay.
I didn't go full Regis on you and say final answer. So,
right.
Major League Baseball, the way this works, I will give you the team and the player. Give me their jersey number on that team. You will have 30 seconds on the clock. You do have one pass if you need it. Any questions before we get started?
No questions.
All right. Your time will start when you hear the horn. Mark McGwire, Oakland A's.
33.
Incorrect. Aaron Judge, New York Yankees.
99.
Correct. Nomar Garciaparra, Boston Red Sox.
21.
Incorrect. Mark McGwire, Oakland A's.
Oh. 38.
Incorrect. Nomar Garciaparra, Boston Red Sox.
22.
Incorrect. Mark McGwire, Oakland A's.
30.
Incorrect. Nomar Garciaparra. Hey, you got one. You got Aaron Judge with number 99. Big Mac, Mark McGwire with the A's, wore number 25, and Nomar with the Red Sox wore number 5. Those were the two you didn't get, but one is better than zero, right?
That's right.
All right. Stay on the line. We'll see if it holds up. You do win any ties, by the way of going first. Dennis in Wake Forest, you there?
Rock and roll. Let's go.
All right. Pick your category. We have NFL Purdue alum, NFL Arizona State alum, or NHL Canes and Whalers only.
All right, let's go Purdue alum.
All right. All of these NFL players played their college football at Purdue. I will give you the team in the NFL and the player. Give me their jersey number with that team. There will be 30 seconds on the clock. You have one pass. Any last-second questions?
No, sir.
All right. Your time will start when you hear the horn. Drew Brees, New Orleans Saints.
9.
Correct. Raheem Mostert, Miami Dolphins.
42.
Incorrect. Rod Woodson, Pittsburgh Steelers.
26.
Correct. Rondale Moore, Arizona Cardinals.
Pass.
Mike Alstott, Tampa Bay Buccaneers.
40.
Correct. Raheem Mostert, Miami Dolphins.
41.
Incorrect. Rondale Moore, Arizona Cardinals.
20.
Incorrect. Raheem Mostert, Miami Dolphins. You got 3. That's actually a very, very solid number. Purdue. I don't know if I would have placed all these guys at Purdue. Drew Brees, you got with 9. Raheem Mostert with the Dolphins has worn both 27 and 31, so we would have taken either. You got Rod Woodson. Rondale Moore with the Cardinals wore number 4. And Alstott, you got that one as well with number 40. Congratulations, you're the winner.
All right, thank you so much, guys. Appreciate it.
You're very welcome. Sit on the line, and Graham will get some info he needs from you to make sure you get your prize. In the meantime, we're going to try to hook up with Dennis Cox one more time here because we need to get his picks. I don't know what Graham is pointing at here. Graham, go ahead and jump on the mic.
Right now or next segment?
Oh, okay. We'll do it next segment. See, got to stay on the move here.
Thought you wanted him to make your picks because I wasn't good enough for make your. No, I'm joking.
No, we have to get Dennis's pick because we're not going to let him go into the weekend without making a pick.
Looks like Dennis is making friends right now, actually, from my camera.
We could have. Well, if he can jump on right now, or we can wait. We'll figure all that out. In the meantime, there's a Casey Morsell clip I want to play here. Do you have that audio? All right, cool. Casey Morsell, veteran guard for NC State, was asked if they see themselves as an underdog. Here's that audio.
Not at all. I mean, if this was the regular season, I feel like whatever, our 9-game stretch will have us number 1 in the country. So this is a new season for us. This is that was our approach heading into this postseason. And, it's something, this momentum that we built up, it's we understand it, we deserve it. But we remember just 2 weeks ago when we didn't have any support at all.
That's the difficulty of the situation they're trying to weave mentally, right? Are you an underdog? Absolutely not. But we remember when absolutely nobody believed in us and they still don't. It's like, wait a second. Isn't that kind of an underdog theory? Here's my breakdown of NC State's mentals right now. They are confident, but they understand what's stacked against them and they understand the world doesn't necessarily believe in them. And I think that's a really good place to be. They've been there for a month. Guys like Casey Morsell, they get it and they're making sure the team stays on the same wavelength they've been. Very little wavering. I'm going to go ahead and take a break here, but when we come back, we will make our picks. We will hear from Dennis. We'll hear from Graham. You'll hear from me, and we'll get you set for the Final 4. Stick around.
Dennis Cox here for my friends over at Law Tigers. Today's the day. Nearly 37,000 of you signed up to win the custom Hurricanes Harley-Davidson Softail Motorcycle that the Law Tigers, Tobacco Road Harley-Davidson, Shiny Side Paint, and your Carolina Hurricanes all teamed up to give the ultimate Canes fan. And guess what? It's going to be given away live on the ice today between the first and second period. I'm excited to see who walks away with a brand new motorcycle. Law Tigers, North Carolina's motorcycle lawyers. Law Tigers is a network of independent law firms who are members of the American Association of Motorcycle Injury Lawyers. Law Tigers is not a law firm.
Getting ready to take on spring? Make your first move with the reliable performance and power of Steel battery tools. From hedge trimmers and mowers to string trimmers and more, save on select Steel battery tools. Right now, save $50 on the RMA 460V lawnmower battery set. Real Steel. Find yours at steeldealers.com. With AK30 battery and AL101 charger. Offer valid for a limited time only while supplies last. See participating dealer for details.
The moment we've been waiting for has arrived. Download the Caesars Sportsbook app today using code NEWNCBG. Then place your first bet of $5 or more. Win or lose, you'll receive $150 in bonus bets. Open to new users in North Carolina who are 21 or older. Terms and conditions apply. See Caesars.com/promos or the promos tab in the app for full terms. Gambling problem? Call 1-877-718-5543 or visit morethanagamenc.gov. Tribal Casino Gaming Enterprise is a licensed operator by the North Carolina State Lottery Commission.
It's bow time. Something new just dropped at Bojangles. Take the bold taste of a crispy golden chicken supreme that's been seasoned to perfection, then add dill pickles, Carolina Gold barbecue sauce, and a toasted bun that's great on the go. What do you get? You get a Bo's Bird Dog. In fact, you can grab two of them for $5. So when you're on the go, headed to practice, or need a snack, grab a Bo's Bird Dog. Hurry in before they're gone. Available for a limited time. It's bow time.
There's no time like bow time, but sometimes it's go time. No time to stop. Introducing Bojangles' new Bird Dog. A seasoned to perfection Bojangles Chicken Supreme, dill pickles, Carolina Gold barbecue sauce, all on a toasted bun. Great on the go. Try two Bird Dogs for just $5 or a two Bird Dog combo for just $8. Hurry, Bo's Bird Dogs are available for a limited time only. When you're hungry for flavor and value, it's bow time.
Imagine waking up this time next week and being 100% debt-free. No credit cards, no car loan, no personal loan. Hey, it's Dennis Cox. Loan Pronto's Equity Express line of credit can make it happen. Homeowners are turning their home equity into cash almost instantly. With Loan Pronto's AI-based system, you can get approval in about 10 minutes. With almost no documentation, no appraisal, and no hassle, you can get hundreds of thousands of dollars out of your home. Use that money to pay off all your other loans. The average homeowner saves over $850 a month doing this. Listen, your home value is way up. You can use that to wipe out all those credit cards, get some money for a home improvement. Literally hundreds of thousands are at your fingertips, and approval is just minutes away. Call 919-381-1760, 919-381-1760, loanpronto.com, 919-381-1760, NMLS 1661781, subject to lender approval, equal housing lender.
A torn ACL, stress fracture, aching back, a hip that's had it, life on hold, and all you want is to get it back. Enter Wake Orthopedics. Our fellowship-trained orthopedists do it all. General, sports, pediatric, joint replacement, fractures, spine, prevention, advanced diagnostics, progressive treatments, minimally invasive procedures, surgeries, and more. Visit wakemed.org/wakeortho and get back your life.
What could be better than living less than 15 minutes from downtown Raleigh, where you'll soon find an expansive greenway network with walking trails, a pool with a lazy river, and a dog park? How about choosing from a diverse portfolio of plans, including large homes with a three-car garage or Charleston-inspired homes with rear-entry garages? At George's Landing by Mungo Homes, you'll find an exceptional location with an even better lifestyle. Go to Mungo.com today to learn more about George's Landing near downtown Raleigh. Mungo.com.
eBay Motors is here for the ride. Go ahead, feel your engine. Admire that perfectly installed exhaust. Your vehicle's moving along this freeway like it was made from fresh installs and a whole lot of love. With eBay Motors, you get over 122 million parts to keep it running. And with eBay Guaranteed Fit, they'll be the perfect fit every time. Plus, at these prices, well, we're burning rubber, not cash. Keep your ride or die alive at ebaymotors.com. Eligible items only. Exclusions apply.
Is this house a good price compared to others in the area? Are prices going up or down? If I don't make an offer right this very moment, will I miss my chance? These are just some of the questions a home buyer might ask. And these are the sorts of questions an agent who is a realtor can help answer. Because realtors have the expertise, data, and access to specialty training to help you navigate the process of buying a home.
They provide support, guidance, and have your back every step of the way. That's what Realtors do, because that's who we are. Realtors are members of the National Association of Realtors.
The Drive with Tim Donnelly, 99.9 The Fan. We are nearing our send-off, but we can't send you off into the weekend, into the Final Four, both men's and women's, without making our picks, and that includes Dennis all the way from Phoenix. So Dennis Cox, our very own, joining us live from, I believe, Radio Row out there in Phoenix at the Final Four.
That's right.
So Dennis, we need some picks here. We need some choices. We'll start with the women tonight. NC State, South Carolina, heavy favorite. What's your take on how that one breaks?
Well, people that may have listened to me before know that I fully am on the state of North Carolina is greater than the state of South Carolina in all ways, shapes, and forms. So give me the NC State women. Give me the Wolfpack tonight over South Carolina because the state of North Carolina reigns supreme over South Carolina.
All right. And actually, you know, I should have known before asking that question.
Hey, you know what? But the people got to know. The people got to know, Tim. Our barbecue is better, both Eastern and Lexington style. Our beaches are better. Everything about the state's better.
All right. Well, they'll have a chance to prove it tonight. The men's side, it's NC State against Purdue. Spot in the finals on the line. Which way are you leaning?
I can't pick against NC State. I just can't. The way this team is playing right now, the run that they're on, the belief that this team has, I cannot pick against NC State. They've won too many games in a row with so much at stake for it to end. Like you've said before, always bet the heater, right? Mm-hmm. Who's on the heater right now? It's NC State. They're on the streak. You bet the heater. You stick with them. I'll take the Wolfpack.
I'm gonna pull a move you usually pull on me.
What's that?
Give me a score.
Oh, give you a score? Okay, I'll give you 82-76.
82-76. All right. So that's a multi-possession game, multi-score game.
I think it's like, you know, some late free throws, you know, kind of pull it out a little bit.
Anything else? You've been out there in Phoenix since Wednesday. I see you looking down. I don't know if there's notes there. What's your final phrase? We kind of opened up the phone lines earlier for last messages. What's your last message for the listeners from Phoenix?
Enjoy the ride. Enjoy the ride. Have fun with it. Embrace it. Have fun. Also, if you're coming out here to Phoenix, hit me up at the Fan Rookie. I want to talk to you while you're out here for sure. Enjoy this ride. It's fun. You don't get to experience this very often. I know where we're located, obviously, in North Carolina. I feel like we are in the college basketball capital of the world, just the triangle as a whole. Because we really are. We are spoiled with how good State, Duke, Carolina, men's and women's as a whole have been over generations now. We've been so spoiled that it's something like this. It's like, oh, wait a second. Actually, not everyone gets to do this every single year and embrace this, you know. Have fun with the journey, with all of it. And also, big shout out to everyone here, by the way, at Radio Row, because we're right here in Phoenix. Like, all the Arizona State University interns and stuff that are here, the people at Westwood One, like, they've been super awesome here for us. And by the way, thanks to Westwood One, sponsored by Verizon, the network you can rely on for your phone and your home internet. Find the plan that's right for you at verizon.com. But yeah, everyone here has been absolutely great. The whole city has really embraced this too. Phoenix, Glendale, everyone, like this whole region. I get into like a Lyft ride, you know, going to and from the stadium or here to Radio Row, and everyone's just like, oh, you're here for the Final Four? You're here for the Final Four? Someone on my ride today was like, yo, that Zach Edey, you know, DJ Burns matchup, man, I can't wait to watch that. Burns really took it to Filipowski from Duke. I was like, where am I? Like, am I on my way to Chapel Hill or something like that? Like, no, like, I'm out here in Phoenix. And people are talking about it as well. Like, it's amazing how the NC State story really has captivated really the country in terms of sports right now. So continue to embrace the ride.
There you go. Dennis, we appreciate all your work this week. We'll see you next week. Enjoy the game.
Absolutely. I will. We'll be talking to people, Adam Gold and I, 11 a.m. tomorrow right here in the Fan.
There you go. Thank you very much, by the way. And he joined us on the Heister Automotive Group hotline. Graham, me and you have to make our picks here. We have a few more minutes. Why don't you start setting them up so we can knock them out of the park?
All right, Tim Donnelly, who do you believe is going to make the first basket tomorrow?
First basket scoring.
Zach Edey or DJ Burns? The immovable object versus the immovable object, down low.
First basket out of them two or first basket in the game?
First basket in the whole You know,
in the whole game,
let's go whole game.
I think DJ Horn.
I think DJ Horn.
I think NC State is aware that so much of the pregame scouting report is going to be on Burns, and they'll run some kind of loose action to get him a wing jumper. So give me DJ Horn to score the first bucket of the game. After, how about this? I'll even go more specific. Purdue wins the tip, misses a shot, rebound Diarra, Horn on the other end, 2-0 State. Long, like a 20-footer. What else you got for me? Right, by the way, if you have an answer, go ahead and chime in.
I mean, I know I said earlier today on Pat Therapy, which, by the way, you can listen to. It's out now on the Fans YouTube channel.
Whole bunch
and
of
wherever you listen to your favorite podcast. We've done a week's worth of Pat Therapy this week. Empty the tank. That's been the motto. Go check it all out. Be sure to like, share, and subscribe.
Welcome if you got them.
We're almost at 10. We're almost at, what is it? 10,000 subscribers. Yeah, we're almost at 10,000 subscribers.
Follow. Subscribe on YouTube, please. 99.9 The Fan. We are nearing 10,000, and we'd like for you to be one of those 10,000.
Who scores 15 or more points? Fletcher Lohr or DJ Horn?
I think there's a good chance for both. Can I say both?
Sure.
I think there's a good chance for both. You know, so often in these games, and we're guilty of it, when so much attention goes to a post matchup, right? They're number one on the scouting report. The other guys get some open shots, and I think both of those guys are capable of knocking down open shots. So I wouldn't be surprised if they're each in the, you know, I think Horn's probably a little bit more of a dynamic scorer, so put him at like 21.
Yeah.
And put Lawyer at 17, and I think that's well within the realm of possibility.
I don't know why. I just have this gut feeling. I guess just because everybody's been talking about so much that it's going to be the Zach Edey, DJ Burns show, that I feel like there's going to be some scoring that comes from outside the perimeter.
Mm-hmm. No, absolutely. I mean, double teams lead to jump shots.
Yeah.
And both Edey and Burns are very, very talented passers. So if the attention is drawn to those guys, you know, Horn, Lawyer, Smith, Michael O'Connell, like those are the guys that are going to get the open jumpers because of it. Morsell. What else you got? Keep them rolling.
This next question might be a good indicator of who you think is going to be better at playing doubling defense. Okay. I can't even speak anymore. Who scores 20 more points? Zach Edey or DJ Burns?
I think it's a pretty good lock that Edey gets to 20.
Fair. I mean, he just came off, what, a 40-point performance?
And I believe he's had 20 straight on some kind of ridiculous streak. When it comes to NCAA tournament games, he's been scoring a lot. So I think it's a near lock he gets to 20. It's a matter of how hard he has to work for it that decides whether NC State is having a good day or not on defense. I think there's quite a few different ways. DJ Burns can be effective and finish with 18, can be a magnet and attract defense and everything else and finish with 16 points. So if you're making me pick one, I go Edey. And that's no disrespect to anyone. It's just that's Edey's game, and Burns has a little bit different game.
All right, we're going to stay with Zach Edey scoring for a little bit, but okay. We're going to throw another player in there.
Ooh, interesting.
To score 30 more points, Zach Edey or DJ Horn?
30 or more? I think, again, you have to lean Edey. But it's almost an identical answer. It's how hard he has to work for it, right? If he's shooting 64%, 70%, and scoring all those points, that's where the issue is. If he's shooting 50% or less, taking the shots he takes around the bucket, and he's scoring his 25, I think you live with that. You sign up for that right now. If I tell you he shoots 44% and finishes with 28 points, I think NC State signs up for that right now. They go, yes. I think he's probably the most likely to get 30. He's the most likely to get 20. But it's all about how he gets it. It's not just a matter of if he gets it.
Fair enough. All right, to record 10 or more assists, Braden Smith or Casey Morsell?
Interesting. I think it's more likely that State has a 10 assist guy. Because I think they're the way that the game works, there's going to be more like hockey assists for Purdue. I don't know if that's going to be Morsell, though. So I'll go Smith. I think O'Connell might be the guy dishing. And I said this earlier, it's a gut instinct. It's a feeling. I can't explain it. I think Morsell's going to be more of a scorer. I think he's going to be able to fill it up.
It'd be great if Morsell's more of a scorer.
I think I said earlier in bold predictions, 4+3s. I think he could finish, you know, upper teens in points, which I think would be a great day for NC State, like a fantastic development for NC State. So I almost don't want him looking to pass as much as I want him hunting his own shot, which leaves the playmaking to O'Connell and some others. So I'll go Smith.
Last one. To record 14 or more rebounds, Zach Edey or Mo Diarra?
I really like Diarra as a rebounder. I'll go Diarra, but I think Edie's a good bet.
Edie's going to get his fair share too.
There's a reason why Edie is like player of the year nationally, Big Ten player of the year. There's like those trophies aren't given away. They're earned. So I'm being very respectful of Zach Edie, but I also want to make sure everybody knows Mo Diarra is a dog on the board.
Shout out to Ramadan Mo.
So give me Mo Diarra in that one. Also, give me a minute right now to tell you about my partners over at Fox & Bailey Watch Shop, located inside Bailey's Fine Jewelry Village District location. We're talking a lot about championships. Well, guess what? A great way to mark a milestone in your life is to grab yourself a high-quality timepiece, right? And that means Omega. Go check out the Omega Boutique inside Raleigh's Village District location of Bailey's Fine Jewelry. It opened in mid-February with a grand opening event. I was there. It was awesome. The window shopping for me was elite. I know what my Grail watch would be. Right? I know what my dream watch would be. It's an Omega Speedmaster. And it's they're coming out with new additions. They have the white dial that just came out. It is historic because of its use in NASA missions. It is stylish. It is complicated when it comes to the movement. It is sharp looking, and it is available at Bailey's Fine Jewelry Village District location inside their Omega Boutique, which is the second largest Omega Boutique of its kind in the entire country. Check out all the Omegas. They're all a very sharp line to wear. They will turn heads, and they're a great way to mark a significant milestone. You get a promotion. Your son or daughter gets married. If you get married, whatever it is, it's a cool way to mark historic milestones in your life. With that being said, we're going to send you off into the Final Four. Don't forget, the state women are playing tonight against South Carolina. The national call will be on WRAL News Plus, 96.5 FM and 99.3 FM. The state home broadcast will be on our friends over at Mix 101.5. The second Final Four game starts at 9 p.m. on WRAL News Plus. That's Iowa and UConn. Enjoy the games. Enjoy the weekend. We'll be here on Monday to break it down. Find Pack Therapy, the pod, everywhere you can find podcasts. Thank you very much. Enjoy Overdrive coming up next with more Final Four conversation. See you on Monday.
Get crazy, Canes fans. It's hockey night in Carolina.
He scores! Dmitri Orlov picks the corner, and the Canes take a 2-1 lead.
Storm Watch with Adam Gold at 6:30. Puck drop at 7.
Second chance, they score! Jesper Fast knocks it home.
On your exclusive home for the Carolina Hurricanes, 99.9 The Fan.
The always ready for breakfast deal.
Going to bed already?
Yep. Breakfast at Mickey D's tomorrow.
So?
Sooner I go to bed, sooner it'll be morning. Sooner I'll be at Mickey D's.
This is actually brilliant.
You can come too. Turn out that light.
There's a deal for every breakfast strategist at McDonald's.
For a limited time, you can buy a bacon, egg, and cheese biscuit or sausage, egg, and cheese McGriddles for only $2.50. Price and participation may vary. Cannot be combined with any other offer or combo meal.
The future of medicine is here at QC Kinetics. QC is the nation's leader in the most exciting revolution in pain management we've seen in decades, regenerative medicine. If you are tired of achy joints, if your joint pain is keeping you from doing what you love, you need to call QC Kinetics now. Surgery, steroids, drugs, these are no longer your best options. Regenerative medicine at QC Kinetics is transforming lives with innovative treatments that deliver lasting results. We're talking natural biologics, using your body's own power to repair and restore damaged tissue. QC Kinetics is under the leadership of National Medical Director Dr. Mitchell Sheencup. Dr. Sheencup is a pioneer in this field with 20 years of clinical work, tons of research, teaching, and publishing. He wants to get you relief with a needle, not a knife. Call QC Kinetics now to learn more about some exciting options. This is a revolutionary approach that can get you long-term relief with no downtime. 919-400-5473 with locations in Cary, Clayton, Raleigh, and Wake Forest. 919-400-5473.
You got a service dog?
Actually, he's a deals dog. Since I'm looking for a new car, I trained him to sniff out awesome rates, member discounts, and fast decisions. Cool, huh?
But you know a Navy Federal Credit Union has all those things, right?
You're right. He's got the scent. Oh, wait. Nope. That's just the bacon in my pocket.
Apply for a Navy Federal Credit Union auto loan online, at a branch, or on our mobile app. Navy Federal Credit Union. Our members are the mission. Message and data rates may apply. Visit NavyFederal.org for more information.
Sports betting has arrived in North Carolina, and Underdog is entering the game. That's right. North Carolina gets Underdog Sportsbook first. Dennis Cox, my friends over at Underdog. Underdog has been working hard behind the scenes to create a sportsbook app using their own technology that caters to you, the sports fan. And that's where Underdog Fantasy makes things simple for you. They're creating an experience for you, the user, and that way you can actually help shape the future of the app. I use Underdog, and it's simple and easy to use. There's a lot of different easy features for you to follow, and that's the reason why I use Underdog Sports app. Download the Underdog Sports app on iOS or Android. Sign up with the promo code Dennis, my name, and use your first bet mulligan, which returns up to $1,000 as bonus funds if your first bet loses. That's Underdog Sportsbook, promo code Dennis. Must be 21 or over to gamble and present in North Carolina. Gambling problem? Call 1-877-718-5543 or visit morethanagame.nc.gov or call 1-800-GAMBLER. Terms, conditions, and restrictions apply and can be found in the Underdog Sportsbook app.
When I was younger, I may have did some stupid things, even committed some crimes. I'm not a criminal.
Youth Advocate Programs is a community-based alternative to youth incarceration, congregate placement, and neighborhood violence. Learn how at yapinc.org.
Hey, everyone. It's Ted from Consumer Cellular, the guy in the orange sweater, and this is your wake-up call. If you're paying too much for wireless service, you don't have to keep having that nightmare. Consumer Cellular has the same fast, reliable coverage as the leading carriers for less. And for a limited time, new customers receive their second month free when they sign up and use promo code MONTHFREE by May 31st. So why keep spending more than you have to? Seriously, wake up and call 1-888-FREEDOM or visit ConsumerCellular.com.
Taxes, fees, and other third-party charges will apply. See website for additional details.
Getting your biggest tax refund from Jackson Hewitt can lead to some spirited reactions.
Jackson Hewitt! Yeah.
Jackson Hewitt is so sure they'll get you your biggest refund that if they don't, you get your money back plus $100.
Jackson Hewitt! Yeah.
Switch to Jackson Hewitt and we'll beat what you paid last year, even if you filed online.
Yeah.
Ain't nothing to it. Switch to Jackson Hewitt and pay less for tax prep, guaranteed. Proof of prior year payment required when filing. New clients only at participating locations through April 7th. Terms at jacksonhewitt.com.
This hour on the Triangle Sports Leader is brought to you by the Ritchie Law Firm Injury Lawyers.
You can feel the madness!
Go to gotbryan.com. That's gotbryan.com.
WCMC HD1 Holly Springs. Take us with you on radio, web, app, Alexa, and YouTube. 99.9 The Fan, the Triangle Sports Leader.
Currently in Raleigh, it is 59 degrees with a high of 62 and a low of 32 tonight. Tomorrow, you're looking at sunny skies with a high of 60 degrees and a low of 37. Weather update brought to you by Habitat for Humanity Restore, now selling brand new solid wood custom cabinets. Learn more at trianglerestores.org. Overdrive is brought to you by Sanford's 150th birthday bash tomorrow from 10:30 to 4. This is a free event happening at Sanford Fairgrounds. Get all the details at sanford150.com. Also, don't forget the Fans Final Four tailgate with Adam Gold and Dennis Cox will be live from 11 to 1 right here on 99.9 The Fan.
It's 6 o'clock. Time to shift into overdrive. All highlights, no filler. As we run it back from the drive with Tim Donnelly.
The Final Four for the NC State women starts tonight. The Final Four for the NC State men start tomorrow. All week we've been building up to this, and this being our final episode of the drive, our final show before those games kick off. And don't try to sell me on it's just any other game. Doesn't it feel like we've been talking about the importance of this game for months now?
Forever.
Imagine how it feels for the players. Imagine everything they've gone through. The Applebee's trips, the practices, the travel, the media opportunities, the walkthroughs. It's not any other game. It's not. It can't be. Pretending it is just ignoring the elephant in the room. As much as the teams try to say there is. By the way, we're going to open up the phone lines here.
Let's go.
Heister Automotive Group Hotline. This is your last chance to get some words in, to get a message in. What's your take? What's your NC State needs to do this to win? They will win because of this. They're going to lose because of that. I don't know. It's open phone lines, 919-860-5326. You'll be hearing from me and Graham throughout the show. We want to hear from you. It's your last chance to get a word in, 919-860-5326, Easter Automotive Group Hotline. It's not just any other game. Despite what Purdue is telling you, here's Fletcher Lawyer, one of their shooters from the outside, talking about how Purdue is treating this Final Four matchup.
It's win or go home, so you got to treat it like a basketball game. It's not a show. It's a game. And I think us being locked in, getting our feel for the court, but ultimately knowing it's still 10-foot rim, same amount of length out there.
Yeah.
Coach's talk.
It is, you know, that's the Hoosiers thing, right? 10-foot rims, it's all the same. I get it. I hear you. It's not any other game. Your heart rate, it's going to be higher at tip-off. The amount of eyeballs, it's being played in a football stadium. The amount of eyeballs on television, it's not any other game. Matter of fact, we have about 40 games, you know, almost 40 games from each team to decide who the good players are and what they need to be successful. I think we have a pretty good idea of what these teams are. But the part we have no research on is how any of these teams, meaning Purdue and NC State, play under the bright lights of Final Four pressure. We know how some of the UConn guys play because we've seen that, but Alabama, Purdue, and NC State, we don't know. And it's not all about, oh, pressure burst pipe. Sometimes pressure